Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the playoffs. Bonnie Walker along with Michael Mosier. We're at Jackie Hendrick Stadium in Princeton, Texas, and it is playoff time in Texas for the Howe Bulldogs for the first time since 2010. The last time the Howe Bulldogs were here, it was a loss to New Boston, 35-0 over in Paris, Texas. But tonight, the Howe Bulldogs looking for a different outcome and the first win for the Howe Bulldogs since 2003. So the Bulldogs prime tonight, even with injuries, looking for a spectacular evening here on the brand new turf. It's a cold, crisp evening here in Princeton, Texas. But as Coach Hudson says, it is absolutely beautiful playoff weather for the Howe Bulldogs tonight. Michael?
Yeah, it's good playoff weather. It's too cold for me to be outside, but it's good weather. I'm excited.
It is nice up here in the booth. We are kind of crammed in here with another broadcast crew. So if you hear somebody else talking, it's the East Texas Broadcast Company out of Paris. They will be also broadcasting this game, but I doubt you'll hear it. And they're a pretty nice fella standing next to us. So let's go over the starting lineup for the Howe Bulldogs. Up front on offense, the left tackle, Josh Griffin, 6'2", 220, and a senior. The left guard, Charles Overby, 5'10", 185, and a senior. The center, Tanner Hartsfield, sophomore, 5'10", 180 pounds. The right guard, Kiefer Rogers, 6'2", 225, and a senior. The right tackle, the freshman, Clay Marshall, 5'10", 235, and the sophomore tight end, Matt Griffin, 6'4", 265 pounds. Up front, the Howe Bulldogs are averaging 218 pounds. That's a lot of beef up front. They have five senior starters on offense, one junior, four sophomores, and one freshman. Caleb Ake is the wide receiver. Brandon Wall will be the slot back. He'll also play some quarterback tonight. Joaquin Lopez, the quarterback, 5'11", 180 senior. He will also play some fullback tonight when they go to the power eye situation. Always dotting the I, Anthony Hawthorne, and always the leading rusher for the Howe Bulldogs. 222 carries, 1,454 yards, 19 touchdowns on the year. He averages 6.6 yards every time he touches the ball. His longest carry of the year, 77 yards. Last week, an astonishing 30 carries for 206 yards. That's quite a workload, and I think that's why you'll see Joaquin Lopez move to fullback a little bit tonight. Brandon Wall play a little bit of quarterback, trying to take a little pressure off of Anthony Hawthorne. Tyler Grisham, 5'11", 200-pound sophomore, plays a running back. He's got 77 carries, 488 yards, and two touchdowns on the season. He averages 6.34 yards per carry. His longest is 54 yards. I would expect you to see a little bit more out of Tyler Grisham than his production last week of 7 carries and 20 yards. Let's go over the starting defense for the Cooper Bulldogs, Michael.
All right, you got strong safety Hadley Ward, free safety Ira Franklin, middle linebacker Tanner Pfeiffer, linebacker Colby Early, cornerback Jake Kane, right cornerback Jaden McCraw, linebacker Colton Strode, right end Clay Ingram, right tackle Casey Mears, left tackle Tristan Jones, and left end Dally Warner.
The starting defense for the Howe Bulldogs, Dalton Felder, who will also play some offense tonight. He still has the broken hand, but he has his fingers able to bend now, so he'll be able to carry the ball a little bit better this week if he's asked to do so. But he's a linebacker, 5'8", 170, and a junior. The middle linebacker, Dylan Moreau, 5'9", 190, a freshman. And outside linebacker, another freshman, 5'9", 180, Andrew Griffin. The cornerbacks tonight for the Howe Bulldogs, Quentin Griffin and Easton Ross, but you'll also see a heavy dose of Nick Wilson, 5'10", 160. He's a junior. The strong safety tonight, Anthony Hawthorne, 5'10", 175, a senior. And also Levi Merzinski plays the weak safety, 6'1", 165. He is a junior. Let's go over the starting offense for the Cooper Bulldogs, Michael.
Left tackle, Zach Jester. Left guard, Clay Ingram. Center, John Vaughn. Right guard, Casey Mims. Right tackle, Skyler Sharpton. Wide receiver, Jack Kane. Slot back, Tanner Pfeiffer. Quarterback, Jaden McGraw. Wide receiver, Justin Gibson. Slot back, Dally Warner. And fullback, Ira Franklin.
We had a chance before the game to talk to Coach Hudson. And let's hear what he had to say.
Coach, an absolutely beautiful night for football here. Perfect, crisp weather, and this is what it's all about, right?
Absolutely. You can't ask for better weather. It's cool, no wind, and beautiful stadium, and some kids ready to play some ball.
I know we're done with last week, but let's talk about the offense a little bit. When this thing goes, you're undefeated when two ball carriers have over 100 yards. Last week, Hawthorne kind of shouldered the load with 30 carries. Do you see it kind of spreading out a little bit more tonight?
I will. You know, it was one of those things we had to get used to some other people being in there and trying to find out what they do better, you know, in live game situation. You know, as much as you practice it, you can't replace game time. The good thing is Leonard's a heck of a football team, and so it was easier to, you know, gave us a good look at what we could possibly do with some other kids. So you'll see some different things, but for the most part, it's, you know, we do what we do, and so does Cooper, so it'll be a fun football game.
Defensively, looking at Cooper, what do you expect to see from them tonight?
Oh, they're going to run the ball, try to run it down your throat all night long. They're going to throw it about four times a game. But they run a little tunnel toss, and they're going to try to hit right over our ends and try to outnumber us sometimes and put us in some bad situations. But, you know, for us, we got to keep it simple and make sure our kids know where to go and know what to do. And as long as we line up right and play as hard as we've been playing, I think we'll be okay.
Your team is extremely young. How are they handling this playoff pressure, if you will?
They have no idea how to handle it. And so the good thing is a lot of these coaches have been there and done that. And so, you know, we've been able to guide them through this and try to tone down some of the things that need to be toned down and ramp up some of the things that need to be ramped up. So, you know, that's the good part about it. But you can't replace experience. But sometimes having that newness in you and not knowing what it's like and wanting to fight for it just so you can experience it again helps you out.
And we all know about the injuries with the ACLs from the normal crew, but anybody else, is everybody else ready to go?
Yeah, everybody's ready. You know, I think if they were hopping on one leg right now, if the doc gave them a note to say go, they'd be going. So everybody's ready. Everybody's dressed out except for those ACL guys. And one had surgery yesterday. Another one's having surgery next week. So, but other than that, we're ready to go.
In your second year here, already in the playoffs, is this where you expected to be?
Absolutely. We're going to expect this every year. And without our expectations being here, you know, we wouldn't be here. So our kids expect it. Our goal is to hit the third round every year. After that, everybody's good. No telling what will happen. But our goal is to get there. We got to play to Thanksgiving every year and get these kids some experience. And, you know, I tell them all the time I want them to tell a story. And I want this to be their story. So.
All right, that's Coach Zach Hudson. We'll be back with more Howe Bulldogs football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Freddy's Restaurant is family-owned and run. They have the cure for all your home cooking cravings. Chicken fried steak, loaded baked potato, bacon patty melt, grilled chicken salad, cheese fries, jalapeno stuffed peppers, and more. Don't forget to save room for that cheesecake and cobbler with ice cream. We know you're going to love the food and the service. Abby's Restaurant in downtown Howe. They're open from 11 to 8, Monday through Saturday. Give them a call, 903-487-8860. Abby's Restaurant.
The Bulldogs make the playoffs and you get the payoff. Hi, this is Chris with Cavender Home Theater. Through November, we're going to give you a $100 Visa gift card just for signing up for Dish with Cavender Home Theater. That's on top of $400 in discounts and free installation. So get the hopper with the best DVR, more HD channels, commercial skip on recorded primetime shows, and lots of apps like Sports Finder and TV Anywhere. Upgrade your home and save money. Visit us at CavenderTV.com or call us at 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
For my family, life is a series of celebrations, from my newest born cousin to my grandmother. We all partake in births, weddings, and funerals. Wherever we celebrate, we need to feel welcome. That's why we choose Scoggins Funeral Home and Howe. Scoggins Funeral Home understands our needs. Talk to the caring staff at Scoggins Funeral Home. Call 903-532-5577 or visit ScogginsFuneralHome.com.
GCEC Wireless, located in Van Alstine off of Exit 51, can help you with all your Verizon wireless needs. They have a wide range of products and services, including smartphones, wireless home and mobile internet, wireless home phone service, and accessories. They're also your local DirecTV dealer. So come on by or call them at 903-712-2355. That's GCEC Wireless. And go Bulldogs!
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium here in Princeton, Texas. Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier and Stephen Braswell will be up here shortly. He is doing the tunnel. They're part of that crew that blows up the tunnel that the team runs through. The Howe Bulldogs overall in the playoffs are 9-15-3. Dating back to the very first playoff game in 1938. It was a bi-district playoff loss on the field, 7-6 to Anna. However, Anna used an ineligible player. That's what they do over there in Anna, right, Mr. Mosier?
Well, what can I say?
So Howe filed an appeal in 1938 that Anna had used an ineligible player, and they actually won that appeal. So there is a bi-district trophy in the trophy case from 1938 for Howe, even though they lost the game on the field 7-6. The last playoff win, as we mentioned earlier, came in 2003 with a 21-14 win over Grand Saline. All nine teams that Howe has, or nine wins that Howe's had in the playoffs are against nine different teams. Howe has scored 320 points in the playoffs, given up 535. The last shutout that Howe threw in the playoffs was back in 1985, and that was also Grand Saline. And I tell you what, it's been a long time coming for the Howe Bulldogs. 2010, obviously the great year, had the great regular season at 9-1, but a quick exit, 35-0 loss to New Boston in that. It was actually, I guess, the second round, because Howe had a first-round bye, so they were bye district champions without even winning a game, which is kind of weird to me, but they ended up being bye district champions that year and did not win a playoff game. This current Howe Bulldog team does their damage in the second quarter. They've scored 84 points in the first, but by far the most, 104 points in the second quarter. Now, Howe, if they're going to continue a playoff run here, is going to have to start picking up in the second half. Only 48 third-quarter points and only 36 fourth-quarter points. The Howe scored 272 points overall and given up 225. They've also given up the most points in the second quarter, 82. So Howe Lifetime versus Cooper, it's not very good. 1-7. Against Cooper. The series dates back to 1978. Howe's only win came the next year in 1979. It was a 6-0 win at Bulldog Stadium in Howe. Howe has scored 63 points against Cooper, and Cooper has scored 210 against the Howe Bulldogs. Probably the most popular game in school history with Howe and Cooper was in 1989. Howe had their best senior class since 1970. And we're just out of the top ranked spot. Cooper came into that game ranked number 8 in the state. Had, of course, Byron Bam Morris, and Byron Bonds that year that led their football team. Also on that team was Ronnie Green, the head coach here at Cooper. That young man was the fullback in front of Bam Morris that night and that year. He was a senior on that team. And I happened to be a sophomore on that team, so I got to play against Bam back in the day. So the Howe Bulldogs are going to have to change some things here against Cooper. Again, their one loss record against Cooper, 1-7 overall, dating back to 1978. Zach Hudson, the head coach of the Howe Bulldogs. He's from Rockwall, Texas, very close to here. His wife is Carrie. She's a former head volleyball coach. They have two daughters, Kai and Bodie, 7 and age 4. Coach Hudson went to Navarro College, Texas A&M Commerce, and played football at both. His record here at Howe is 8-12. He's the 25th head coach in Howe history. His coaching stops at Garland Lakeview, Weimer as the defensive coordinator, LaGrange the defensive coordinator, back to Weimer as the head coach and athletic director, and now Howe as the head coach, athletic director. One more win for Zach Hudson will tie him with Arthur Boyle with 9 wins in school history. We're going to take a quick timeout and be back with more Howe Bulldog football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Think back to the best fried pie you've ever had. It won't compare to Sweetie Pies in Van Alstine. They have handmade apricot, apple, peach, buttermilk, chocolate, coconut, and lemon fried pies that melt in your mouth. Located at 120 South Main Street in Van Alstine on the east side of downtown. Give them a call at 903-712-PIES. That's 903-712-7437. Sweetie Pies can also make custom Howe cookies, muffins, and other baked goods.
It's way too hot for your vehicle's AC to go out. Head over to 4A Automotive and Howe for their special air conditioning service checkup for just $39.95. For over 10 years, they've provided the most reliable and dependable service and repairs in the area. 4A Automotive is a bumper-to-bumper service shop. They do it all, from autos to diesels, and they're front-end specialists, too. So call 4A Automotive today at 903-546-0024. They're located 4 miles east of Howe at the corner of FM 902 and Luella Road.
Calling all Bulldog fans to come down to the Sonic and Howe for half-price shakes after 8 and open until midnight, home games only, where you get great food and big smiles. And a little message for all our Howe football players, go Bulldogs fight, Bulldogs win, win, win. Because it's not just good, it's Sonic good.
You're invited to the one and only Buck Snort Barbecue in downtown Van Alstine, Texas. Your friends and neighbors say it's the best barbecue in North Texas. Now it's your turn to decide. Come taste the difference at Buck Snort Barbecue. For complete store information, including menu, location, and hours, click on BuckSnortBarbecue.com. That's BuckSnortBBQ.com. Buck Snort Barbecue in downtown Van Alstine is a proud supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
Welcome back to Princeton, Texas, to Jackie Hendricks Stadium. I'm going to remember that.
Yeah, you almost said Bulldog Stadium.
At some point, I'm going to have to remember Jackie Hendricks Stadium because I had a hard time with that. It is a beautiful night over here in Princeton. If you had a chance to go to HoweEnterprise.com and look at some of those pregame photos, the western sky was just beautiful as the Bulldogs came out for their pregame warm-ups. Punting and kicking teams came out. It was just absolutely gorgeous towards the western sky. Of course, the sun has gone down. It's a dark evening now, but we're way up here in the sky here at Jackie Hendricks Stadium.
You're working hard on that.
I am. I'm going to get it. Both teams preparing in the locker room have not yet made it out on the field. The actual blow-up tunnels are just now starting to be messed with. So in a few moments, we'll have the teams getting ready to come out on the field. Howe will be in their all-white, white pants and white jerseys with black numerals, black helmets, black face masks, black shoes and socks. And their most familiar road uniform. Now the Cooper Bulldogs, they will be in their all maroon. Maroon pants, maroon jerseys, maroon helmets. So
please tell me white numbers.
Yes, okay. They are white numbers. They're going to be easy to read. Unlike, what do we have? S&S was just awful. And was it White Right? White Right, you just couldn't tell who they were, those two teams.
White Right were awful. They were bad, too.
Yeah. So the Howe Bulldogs come in tonight 5-5 on the regular season. Went 3-2 in district, scored 170 points in district, gave up 105. As we mentioned earlier, scored 272 on the season, 225 on the season. Lost last week in overtime to Leonard in a great game in which Anthony Hawthorne had 30 carries for over 200 yards. The Cooper Bulldogs in District 6 started off their season with a loss to Farmersville at Farmersville, 42-32. And then played Reigns and won 21-7 and then lost to Tom Bean 31-30. So it's hard to compare teams versus other teams, especially since Howe plays so much differently than everyone else. They do not throw the football. Their actual goal is to not throw the football one time. So it's so much different to compare Howe to Tom Bean and teams that they've played, the common teams. But Cooper did lose to Tom Bean 31-30. And Howe, of course, probably had their most successful rushing game in school history. They broke the rushing record against Tom Bean several weeks ago, if that gives you any indication of what this game could be.
You know,
however, Stratton Carroll played that game, too.
Yeah, and, you know, first of all, Stratton, if you're listening, buddy, we miss you. We wish you nothing but the best. Hope that you heal and everything is turns out fantastic for you. I know you wish you were here, and we do too. So the best of luck.
Stratton Carroll, 6 foot, 180-pound junior, of course, tore his ACL and found some other information about his MCL when he went in to have surgery last week. Had his MCL flipped over, so you know, a little bit more surgery than what we thought initially going into that, but he'll be on crutches for 6 weeks. That is a very bad injury for the Howe Bulldogs, not only Carroll, but because Carroll had 78 rushes for 896 yards on the season, 8 touchdowns. Every time he touched the ball, he averaged 11.5 yards a carry. So anytime you lose someone who averages a first down for you, that's going to be hard to replace, and it was last week for Howe. And the reason, I mean, that's basically the reason Hawthorne had 30 carries a week ago. Dalton Felder were also kind of trying to fill in that gap a little bit, and also Brandon Wall will play the slot. I don't know how much you'll see Jaden Matthews simply because of the playoff situation, the playoff game. It's an awful lot to expect out of someone who was on JV a couple of weeks ago. But when I say that, you know, Matthews may come out and score 2 touchdowns. Who knows?
He might. But, you know, a couple of these guys will be back next year.
Hey, we need more cowbell.
Right.
Anybody?
Let's see. You know, a couple of these guys, you know, Stratton will be one of them. He'll be back next year. He's going to heal up. He's going to come back 100%. You know, Tristan Matthews is going to still be here. You know, Ty Portman, we miss him. We, you know, he'll be back. You know, these guys are going to I think we're in for a good may be doing this a while.
Yeah, this is a very good time to be a Howe Bulldog fan because a lot of these on the roster, a lot of them are freshmen and sophomores that have been playing all year. It is a team chalked with youth, with Tanner Hartsfield, a sophomore, Clay Marshall, a freshman, and here come the Cooper Bulldogs. They might have a very tiny tunnel, but they do have a loud section.
Yeah.
A loud horn to make up for it.
Yes, they do.
I'm not sure how they got the entire team in that tiny, in that tunnel.
I don't either, but at least they were warm. You know,
it's like a Snoopy, you know, like one of the,
it looks, it
hey, I don't want to be rude, but
you know,
it looks like Snoopy's house.
Yeah. You know, and you look over here at this clock, you know, it's showing temperature. Temperature's already dropped a couple of degrees. It may be down close to 30 by the time we're done.
It shows 38 degrees at the current moment. The Howe Bulldogs still stretching and doing their warm-ups in the end zone. We're going to take a quick timeout. We'll be back with more Howe Bulldog football in just a moment on HoweEnterprise.com.
The Howe Athletic Booster Club invites you to become a supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
The type of kids we have, they're just hard workers and do anything you ask.
Memberships are $25 and will be available at all home games. All proceeds benefit high school and middle school athletic programs. Please join the Howe Athletic Booster Club in our efforts to support our hometown kids.
When people come here, you know, it's something they can be proud of.
The Howe Enterprise has served Howe as the hometown news since 1963. Since then, the Bulldogs have won 8 district, 7 by-district, 3 area championships, and 1 regional title. We've seen 14 different head coaches during that time. The Howe Enterprise has been with the Bulldogs for 51 years. We were there when the pride of Howe won 3 band state championships. HoweEnterprise.com publishes weekly on Mondays.
Carey's Coffee Company in historic downtown Van Alstine, next to the post office, is the new upscale coffee shop serving Van Alstine, Howe, and surrounding areas. Carey's Coffee Company offers a wide variety of organic coffee and non-coffee beverages and baked goods. Come visit Carey's Coffee Company in downtown Van Alstine, next to the post office, and mention this ad and get 50% off your first beverage. Open Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 2 p.m. and 7 a.m. on Saturdays. Carey's Coffee Company is Texas quality.
Your business has a story to tell. Let Fast Signs help you tell it using the right mix of visual communication solutions like signs, banners, digital displays, vehicle graphics, mobile marketing, and so much more. Give Fast Signs your business challenge and we'll come up with a plan to grow your business, reach more customers, and accomplish more than you ever thought possible. Fast Signs. More than fast, more than signs.
Fast Signs Texoma, located at 1916 North Grand Avenue in Sherman, 903-893-SIGN.
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier and Stephen Braswell will be making his way back up here in just a moment. We have the coin toss. Looks like Howe has won the toss. They've deferred. And Howe will kick off to start this football game. Cooper will receive. And you can hear the crowd here all across the way, the Howe Bulldogs on the very far side, visitors making a lot of noise. Of course, Cooper here on the near side have brought quite a few people as well, but Howe's really packed the house over there on the far side.
Yeah, boy, there's absolutely no wind blowing.
I believe we're about to have the national anthem, and we'll let you listen to that as we're ready for that now. Ladies and gentlemen, it is playoff time in Texas. Princeton, Texas, to be exact, Jackie Hendricks Stadium, Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier, the Howe Bulldogs about to enter the field and kick this one away. Honaker, the freshman, will be the young man who will boot this one away and start this playoff run for the Howe Bulldogs. We hope that it is a good run of at least 3 weeks. That's what Coach Hudson said, that's the goal, three rounds. That's the goal for the Howe Bulldogs. No longer the Howe Bulldogs expecting mediocrity. Coach Hudson will have none of that, and it feels like a different era as Coach Hudson in his second year here at Howe definitely has changed the mindset of this athletic program. Back deep to receive for the Cooper Bulldogs will be Colton Strode and Ira Franklin. Now, Franklin, you'll hear a lot of tonight. He will tote the note for the Cooper Bulldogs on offense and carry it quite a bit. And he will be back deep with Strode. Honaker will probably pooch this one, and we'll see. And it's going to be an onside kick, going to be taken by an up man, and he's down immediately. And that on the reception for the Cooper Bulldogs is Dolly Warner. And he will actually take it across midfield. So Warner did a great job of fielding the football and thought about going down for a moment and then actually said, hey, nobody's going to tackle me. I'm going to go for a few yards here. And he did to the 48.
Yeah, Andrew Griffin and Tyler Grisham in on the stop for the Bulldogs.
First and 10. As Cooper will move right to left. This stadium runs east to west. And Cooper is moving to the west, right to left, at the Howe 48-yard line. Just underway. This will be a toss to Franklin. He'll run straight up the middle, break a few tackles. He'll make his way to the 42-yard line and stop right there. A gain of 7 on first down, maybe 6.
Brought down hard by Anthony Hawthorne.
So we're just underway. First play of the game was a 5-yard run by Franklin. Split out wide left to the near side will be Hadley Warden. And this will be McGraw under center. Toss, same play, left side Franklin. This time he's met at the line of scrimmage and a great play by the Bulldogs. J.P. Queen right there along with
Tyler Grisham. And our spotter says Andrew Griffin was in on that as well.
Interesting night for our spotter, who is standing outside of our booth on the film deck, and he has that infrared light that right through the glass can point out who made the tackle and help Mr. Mosier out.
That's right.
But I feel bad for Mr. Braswell standing out in the cold, but he does have his binoculars and he does have a nice warm jacket out there.
And,
third down and 5. And this will be a toss. Franklin again, right up the middle. He's going to be close to a first down. Crosses the 40 to about the 38-yard line, and I believe that's going to be enough to move the sticks. And it is, as Cooper now at the Howe 38-yard line, in between the 37 and the 38.
Andrew Griffin and J.P. Queen in on the stop and for Howe.
Split out. Wide to the top is Warden, and this will be a toss. Again, Franklin up the middle, and this time met right at the line of scrimmage. Nice job there by
Charles Overby.
Overby met him right at the line of scrimmage.
Overby and Queen. Queen had a good ball game last week. He was in on made a lot of tackles last week.
They'll spot the ball at the 36-yard line of Howe, which is a second down and 8.5, perhaps, for Cooper. Again, moving right to left. 9:52 on the first quarter clock. No score, just underway.
Looks like Griffin in on the far end. Maybe, yeah, it looks like Matt Griffin's out there on defense.
Here's a handoff to the new tailback into the game, and that's Tristan Jones. And they're kind of a 1-2 punch in Cooper. Jones and Franklin. And Jones got the carry that time right over right guard. And he's close to a first down. It'll be third and about 2 as the ball is just touching the 30-yard line.
Well, Charles Overby in on a stop for the Bulldogs. We've got a couple of different guys out there this week. Matt come into the ball game. He's playing that tackle position.
T formation, and this will be Jones again moving left tackle. He's got some room for the 25 and busted down to the 18-yard line. I thought for a moment he went down, but somehow duck walked his way to the 15 and finally driven out of bounds by Queen.
And Anthony Hawthorne in on that stop as well as Easton Ross.
That's quite an impressive display of duck walking by Jones. Try to update the score for those looking in.
You know, it looks like I believe we may have to get our spotter to check. Looks like Stratton may actually be in the booth down here.
Here's a carry by Jones to the 15, to the 10. Breaks a tackle into the end zone. Touchdown, Cooper. It is a 14-yard touchdown by the Cooper Bulldogs. Tristan Jones, 6'1", 220 junior. And Cooper goes on top 6-0 with 8:37 left to go in the first quarter.
And it looks like he run over a couple of Bulldogs getting to the outside. Just kind of bowled his way in there.
And we'll see the kicker come on for Cooper, which would be Colby Early. Actually, they're not going to try the PAT. They're going to go for it here. And this will be McGraw handing off to Jones, tossing it to him rather, and he is stopped and stuffed right at the 2-yard line. No gain and no PAT. Cooper leads 6-0 with 8:37 left to go in the first quarter clock. More Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com in just a moment.
This
is Chris Cavender. The holidays are around the corner. Call Cavender Home Theater to get that new TV or audio system delivered and set up by our professionals. We can deliver all that plus dish with one visit by our top-notch team of installers, so you know it's done right. Competitive prices, local service you can depend on. Come see us at 6202 Texoma Parkway in Sherman, online at CavenderHT.com, or give us a call, 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
Abby's Restaurant is family-owned and run. They have the cure for all your home cooking cravings. Chicken fried steak, loaded baked potato, bacon patty melt, grilled chicken salad, cheese fries, jalapeno stuffed peppers, and more. Don't forget to save room for that cheesecake and cobbler with ice cream. We know you're going to love the food and the service. Abby's Restaurant in downtown Howe. They're open from 11 to 8, Monday through Saturday. Give them a call, 903-487-8860. Abby's Restaurant.
The Bulldogs.
The kick goes to Felder. And Felder will take it. Or actually, that's Hawthorne. He'll take it up to the 26-yard line. It was a squib kick. Cooper up 6-0 after the 14-yard Tristan Jones touchdown run. The drive started at the 48, so it was a 48-yard drive that took 3 minutes and 23 seconds off the clock.
Brandon Toon made the stop for the Bulldogs. That's kind of confusing. How about we just go for Cooper?
Hal will start now for the first time with Brandon Wall at quarterback. Toss left side. That's Hawthorne. He's looking for a block. Bowls over one defender at the 28 and goes out of bounds right at the 30-yard line. A gain of about 4 yards on first down. The first offensive play for the Hal Bulldogs in the playoffs since 2010.
Colton Strode made the tackle for Cooper.
Ball rests at the Howe 30, moving left to right towards the east. Hartsfield breaks the huddle, comes to the line of scrimmage. This is Wall at quarterback again. Hand off to Grisham to the near side. He breaks free for enough for the first down, close to the 40-yard line to the 39. Good for about an 8-yard gain.
Jaden McCraw and Jack Kane made the stop.
So Grisham gets tired of wearing something and just throws it to the sideline. That one of the coaches will retrieve it. Not sure what exactly that was, but he didn't want it on him anymore. Hartsfield breaks the huddle, comes to the line of scrimmage. Wall at quarterback. Joaquin Lopez, the fullback, and this is a handoff Hawthorne right through the middle over right guard, and he gains 6 yards up to the 44-yard line. It'll be second down and 5 coming up.
Tanner Pfeiffer and Tristan Jones in on the stop.
Howe in all white, white pants, white jerseys, black helmets, black socks, black shoes, and black numbers. Cooper in all maroon. They look very much like the Sherman Bearcats, if you're familiar. Maroon pants, maroon jerseys, maroon helmets. Here's Lopez at quarterback, and he will I'm not sure exactly what happened there. It was a misdirection play, and I think Lopez ended up being tackled right at the 40, a loss on the play of about 4 yards. We'll set up a third and long situation for Howe.
Yeah, left tackle Tristan Jones made the stop for Cooper.
Third and 9 now. We're at the 6:55 mark in the first quarter. Cooper up 6-0. Big loss on the play. A great job by Cooper. And here's going to be a handoff to Hawthorne, running over right guard initially, bounces out to the left side, and he's going to gain maybe a yard. It'll be fourth and long, and Mr. Overby will punt for the first time tonight.
Colton Strode, Colby Early made the stop for the Bulldogs.
So Howe's drive, which started, I believe, at the 28, will stall out here at the 41-yard line. And Overby will get a low snap, dig it out, and kicks it off the side of his foot. Terrible punt. Goes off the side of his foot as he tried to rush it because it was a bad snap. There is a flag down at the 29-yard line. We'll have to check and see what that was, but the punt went straight up, and it actually would be credited a 4-yard punt. But it is a penalty against Cooper. So scratch all of that. And Overby will be thankful for that, for his punting average, because that would have really brought it down. A four-yard punt, something that this former punter knows all about, those shanks. And those are hard on a defense. But we'll see what happens here. It'll be a five-yard penalty. It'll be fourth down again, and I believe Howe's going to still punt it here. It'll move the ball to the 46-yard line, and I believe Overby is still going to punt. And he is. It's fourth and about three. Just shy of midfield at the 46-yard line. Good snap this time, and this time Overby bangs it away. It'll bounce at the 29 and take a good Howe roll inside the 20, rolling toward the far sideline and killed at the 16-yard line. So a great punt by Overby. He gets a second chance at it instead of a four-yard punt. Booms one with the great roll at the end. And now Cooper will take over at their own 16-yard line with the ball on their end for the first time tonight on their second drive. There's 5:48 on the clock here in the first quarter, and Cooper leads 6-0. McGraw brings them to the line of scrimmage. And a wing T formation. This will be a toss. And that's Franklin coming to the near side. He's fast. Got the 20. Got the 25. Breaks a tackle. And then finally brought down. I think there was a fumble on the play, but the official says it is Howe's ball. Howe has recovered the football at the 36-yard line. Franklin put it on the turf.
Recovered by Levi Brzezinski.
So Howe now takes over on a huge, huge opportunity with Franklin putting it on the turf.
You know, that's one of them that just, you know, just running back just hastily, it just bounced right out of his hand.
So now in Cooper territory at the 37-yard line with 5:39, Howe takes over. And this will be a handoff up the middle. Hawthorne will carry it on first down for a couple of yards, and he'll cross the 35. Nah, actually, he won't. He'll be just shy of the 35.
Dally Warner and Tristan Jones in on the stop.
So Howe's going to really need to capitalize here. You know, they had so many opportunities a week ago in Leonard territory. I believe had four consecutive drives start in Leonard territory, did not capitalize on any of them. And they're going to have to start doing that, especially right here in this playoff game. Lopez under center, sends Brandon Wall in motion. Hand off Hawthorne, left side, breaks through for maybe one, maybe two. He will cross the 35 this time to the 34-yard line, just inside the 34, possibly to the 33. 4:51 on the first quarter clock. Cooper leads 6-0.
Tanner Pfeiffer and Casey Mills in on the stop.
Third and six coming up for Howe. Moving left to right here at Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Lopez under center. Hawthorne in motion. He gets the carry. Moving left side. Trying to find a block. Gets a great one by Grisham, but other pursuers find Hawthorne. And they'll bring him down right at the 30-yard line, 3 yards shy of the first down. We'll see what Coach Hudson elects to do here, and I would imagine this is four-down territory for Howe as they'll go for it right here on fourth and three. Big play already in this first quarter for Howe.
Emilio Zapata made the stop for the Bulldogs.
Zach Blevins brings the play in, and he'll be the tight end. Actually, he'll split out wide right. Man in motion. Handoff coming near side. Hawthorne. He's got the 30. Shakes a defender and goes to the 25-yard line. I believe he's got enough for the first down, and he does. A great second effort by Hawthorne of just juking that last defender. I thought for a moment he was going to get himself in trouble and lose yardage and not get the first, but he actually did get enough to move the sticks here. 3:40 on the first quarter clock. Howe driving with a new set of downs at the 25-yard line of Cooper.
And Dally Warner and Tanner Pfeiffer in on the stop.
Hartsfield comes to the line of scrimmage. Lopez, the quarterback. And he will hand off to Tyler Grisham on the left side. He breaks through for about five, and he'll barrel his way to the 20-yard line as several defenders were hanging over Grisham, but that did deter him from gaining 5 yards. 3:08 on the first quarter clock. Howe trailing Cooper 6-0, but knocking on the door here at the 20-yard line.
Yeah, Colby Early made the stop for Cooper.
And this will be Quentin Harris bringing in the play for Howe. And he'll go to the left tight end slot. Lopez, handoff Grisham again. Same play. He's got the 15. He's got the 10. Dragging a man to the 5. Kiss him goodbye. It is touchdown time in Texas. Howe is on the board for the first time in the playoffs in 2014. The first time the Howe Bulldogs have put points on the board since 2003 in the playoffs. Hello, Tyler Grisham.
Yes, sir. Good job by Tyler. You know, good job by all the Bulldogs. But, you know, Tyler Grisham just there. He never give up.
That was a nice 15-yard touchdown run, I believe, by Grisham. And right now the game's tied 6-6. We'll see about this PAT by the freshman Honaker. And the kick is looks good. And it is 7-6. Howe in the lead with 2:38 left to go in the first quarter. Howe's first lead of the game. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldogs football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Make the playoffs and you get the payoff. Hi, this is Chris Cavender. The holidays are around the corner. Call Cavender Home Theater to get that new TV or audio system delivered and set up by our professionals. We can deliver all that plus dish with one visit by our top-notch team of installers so you know it's done right. Competitive prices, local service you can depend on. Come see us at 6202 Texoma Parkway in Sherman, online at CavenderHT.com, or give us a call 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
Abby's Restaurant is family owned and run. They have the cure for all your home cooking cravings. Chicken fried steak, loaded baked potato, bacon patty melt, grilled chicken salad, cheese fries, jalapeno stuffed peppers, and more. Don't forget to save room for that cheesecake and cobbler with ice cream. We know you're going to love the food and the service. Abby's Restaurant in downtown Howe. They're open from 11 to 8, Monday through Saturday. Give them a call, 903-487-8860. Abby's Restaurant.
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Honaker is going to do the same onside kick here. It's going to be bobbled a little bit, but I believe Cooper was able to get back on it at the 40-yard line. They'll actually give Cooper the ball at the 42. So they did recover, but wow, what a scary moment there for the Cooper Bulldogs as it looked like Howe might recover again and be in great
position. Yeah, that would have been in great territory.
So Cooper does recover. 2:34 left on the first quarter clock. Howe now in the lead, 7-6, after a 3-minute and 1-second drive that went 37 yards. It was capped off by a Tyler Grisham 15-yard touchdown run. First and 10. Cooper's going to hand off or toss left side. That's Franklin again. He's got some room to the 45. He's met and drug. And I believe that is Griffin. Griffin hit him and took a ride.
Griffin and Marinsky in on the stop.
And the ball will now be spotted in Howe territory at the 46-yard line. Moving the sticks. Franklin's pretty quick, and he has lots of room to run on that toss to the near side. Howe has just not been able to stop that toss. The only time they've stopped it is when Franklin put it on the turf.
Yeah, he covered it up that time. He wasn't going to lose it.
Warden will be split out to the top. And this will be a toss, flag down. Franklin right up the middle. He's got some room, splits out to the 35-30. And he is finally brought down at the 20 by Dalton Felder. But I have a feeling the flag is going to go against Howe, as I believe one of the defenders was in the neutral zone there when the ball was snapped.
And Dalton Felder made a stop for the Bulldogs.
I think it's going to be declined. And yeah, it is against the Bulldogs. So now the Cooper Bulldogs setting up in pretty good shape at the Howe 20. As Franklin is just very quick and always has his feet moving forward, and he's just hard to bring down. Not only is he quick, he's hard to tackle.
Yeah, he was just bouncing off of it.
Franklin is 6'2", 180. He's a tall individual, tall, thin, but he's very quick. And this time it'll be Jones, and he'll run to the right side. He's got some room. He's got the 15 to the 10 to the 5, and he is down at the 2-yard line.
Anthony Hawthorne made the stop for the Bulldogs.
That is a very beefy young man. Is Tristan Jones, 6'1", 220, and junior. He is it's like a tank out there.
Yeah, he does.
So it'll be first and goal for Cooper from the.
We have a.
I think
we,
it's the 3-yard line.
Yeah, we have a tank stump. They have a tank.
That's right.
Looks like Bonnie Lonoke has scored on S&S. Looks like they are fixed to move into the second quarter. 7-0 Lonoke.
First and goal from the 2. McGraw under center. Toss. That's Jones, and he's met at the 1-yard line. And a nice play there up front.
Austin Beard.
I believe that was Beard.
6'3", 250 junior.
Yeah, Beard. Getting a lot of playing time lately with Menevar out.
Yeah, you know, I saw him last night at the pep rally. That's a big young man.
Yep.
He is tall.
Warden bringing the play in very calmly and just kind of trotting. No sense of urgency at all. 108 on the clock in the first quarter.
He wasn't in no hurry.
He was not in a hurry. Here's McGraw coming to the line of scrimmage. Jones is the only man in the backfield. McGraw is going to toss it to him, left side. He barrels his way forward and is stopped at the 1-yard line. A flag is down.
Looks like the tank was stopped by the stump.
The stump would be Tristan Matthews, 5'9", 215 junior. He also wears 44. Jones wears 44, so this will be a personal foul against Cooper. That's huge. That's a big, big penalty. Big, big penalty. As the second down carry will now go backwards. Even if Jones had got in there, that's a big penalty.
Yeah,
that would have negated a touchdown if he got in. He didn't, however. It was a great stop by Howe, by Stump Matthews. But we'll check and see now where they're actually going to spot the ball, as they've not marked it off yet. Coach Ronnie Green is not happy. He's out there talking to the official. And now they're going to mark the ball off and spot it. In between the 16 and the 17-yard line. Huge penalty. Second down now and goal from the 16. That, my friends, is huge.
That was big.
That could be a game changer of a penalty. As here come the Cooper Bulldogs out to the line of scrimmage. 2 men in the backfield. Jones still in the backfield along with Dolly Warner. And this is going to be McGraw looking to throw for the first time. He's got lots of room to run, and he actually does throw. And that's going to be caught by Warner. And he will be inside the 5. I think they'll actually mark him at the 5.
Anthony.
If McGraw wanted to run there, he might have been able to run it in himself. Lots of room.
There was quite a bit of room right there. Anthony Hawthorne made the stop.
So it'll be third down now and goal from the 5 for the Cooper Bulldogs.
Like Colby Early checking into the game for the Bulldogs.
Early is a 6 foot, 210 senior. Most of these Cooper Bulldogs are seniors. A timeout, and actually the first quarter has ended. Howe has won the first quarter. We'll see if they can win the next 3. 7-6 as we enter the second. We'll be back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
Abby's Restaurant is family-owned and run. They have the cure for all your home cooking cravings. Chicken fried steak, loaded baked potato, bacon patty melt, grilled chicken salad, cheese fries, jalapeno stuffed peppers, and more. Don't forget to save room for that cheesecake and cobbler with ice cream. We know you're going to love the food and the service. Abby's Restaurant in downtown Howe. They're open from 11 to 8, Monday through Saturday. Give them a call, 903-487-8860. Abby's Restaurant.
The Bulldogs make the playoffs and you get the payoff. Hi, this is Chris with Cavender Home Theater. Through November, we're going to give you a $100 Visa gift card just for signing up for Dish with Cavender Home Theater. That's on top of $400 in discounts and free installation. So get the hopper with the best DVR, more HD channels, commercial skip on recorded primetime shows, and lots of apps like Sports Finder and TV Anywhere. Upgrade your home and save money. Visit us at CavenderTV.com or call us at 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium here in Princeton, Texas. Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier and Stephen Braswell, who is probably freezing outside, but doing a great job spotting through the window.
That makes it nice.
We are now in second quarter action as Howe's leading 7-6 in this bi-district playoff game here in Princeton. And Cooper is knocking on the door here at the 5-yard line. It'll be third and goal from the 5. McGraw, toss, right side, and that's going to be Jones. And Jones is in for the touchdown for the second time tonight.
You know, Cooper had a lot of beef in the backfield. They had Jones and Early. Jones, like you say, is 6'1", 220. Early was he's 6 foot 210. Boy, that's a lot to be coming at you.
So Jones scores from the 5-yard line. And now he'll get the carry on the 2-point conversion and lots of room there, and he's easily in. So a 2-point conversion for Jones. And he's done all of the scoring so far tonight for the Cooper Bulldogs. So our new score, 14-7, Cooper in the lead with 11:55 left to go in the second quarter. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
For my family, life is a series of celebrations, from my newest born cousin to my grandmother. We all partake in births, weddings, and funerals. Wherever we celebrate, we need to feel welcome. That's why we choose Scoggins Funeral Home and Howe. Scoggins Funeral Home understands our needs. Talk to the caring staff at Scoggins Funeral Home. Call 903-532-5577 or visit ScogginsFuneralHome.com.
GCEC Wire.
Abby's Restaurant is family owned and run. They have
GCEC Wireless, located in Van Alstine off of exit 51, can help you with all your Verizon wireless needs. They have a wide range of products and services, including smartphones, wireless home and mobile internet, wireless home phone service, and accessories. They're also your local DirecTV dealer. So come on by or call them at 903-712-2355. That's GCEC Wireless. And go Bulldogs!
Here is the kickoff, and it's going to be taken by Howe. It's a squib kick that Zach Blevins will recover. And Howe will start in pretty good field position at their own 41-yard line. So there's 11:53 on the second quarter clock. The Cooper drive. Well, here's a toss right side. That's going to be Anthony Hawthorne. He's going to be caught in the backfield. A loss of about 3 on first down. And that doesn't happen very often. And Coach Dale West, not happy with somebody on offense, barks something out, walks halfway out to the numbers, and says a little something to one of the offensive players. The Cooper Bulldogs drove 59 yards on that last possession to score. Tristan Jones, his second touchdown of the night. Under center, this is Lopez. Handoff to Tyler Grisham, who has lots of running room up to close to midfield to the 48-yard line. About a 10-yard run by Tyler Grisham, and that little reverse to the other side seems to be working right now for the Howe Bulldogs.
Yeah, Jaden McCraw made the stop for the Bulldogs.
Third down and 3. As Howe now moving right to left, 10:52 on the second quarter clock, trailing Cooper 14-7 in the first round of the 2014 playoffs. Lopez, handoff, Grisham flagged down as he'll gain enough for the first down, but we'll have to check. This is probably going to be against Howe. as it was thrown as soon as the whistle, as soon as the ball was snapped.
Dally Warner. It looked like the tackle on this side may have been in the neutral zone, or he may have lined up off sides.
Are they going to back this one up? Actually, no. I think this was going to be against Cooper, and it is. Yeah, defensive offsides. That'll be a first down regardless. They'll spot the ball to the Cooper 47-yard line. Big penalty there for Cooper. They've had a couple of big penalties. It hasn't really cost them yet.
Yeah, not yet. But, you know, you can't let them penalties happen, or it will cost you in the long run.
First and 10 for Howe. As Caleb Ake will bring the play in. Hartsfield breaks the huddle, goes to the line of scrimmage. Here comes everybody else. Lopez under center. And he will hand off. I believe he gave to Hawthorne up the middle. Again, misdirections sometimes hard to find. And it'll be no gain on the play. Hawthorne, they might actually give him a yard there.
Cole.
They'll spot the ball in between the 46 and the 47-yard line.
Yeah, he was met hard by Tristan Jones.
You might hear the other broadcaster standing next to us. That's a favorable spot. I agree.
Yeah, that was
Here is Wall under center, handoff Hawthorne, and he'll gain two. We just haven't seen a lot of Hawthorne breaking free so far. Usually you'll have at least one Hawthorne very long run, and we just haven't seen that yet tonight.
Yeah,
it's very early, though.
It is. It's early. Tristan Jones, again, made the stop for Cooper.
Third and seven for Howe, moving right to left, 9:25 on the second quarter clock, trailing Cooper 14-7. Man in motion. This is going to be Hawthorne coming near side, 45. He's got the 40 and just lowers his shoulder and takes one Cooper defender out as he's close to a first down on the near side. It's going to be very close to that first down, and I believe he's got it. They are going to move the sticks at the 37-yard line.
And contact. He made contact with Ira Franklin, but I think Mr. Franklin felt a little bit more of that contact than Anthony.
Hawthorne just actually leveled it. It's not going to be a first down. It's going to be short by a yard. Now, what they had a gracious spot a moment ago. I don't think that was a very good spot at all.
No, matter of fact, I think the official picked it up, backed it up a little bit.
Here we go, fourth and one. Handoff, Hawthorne, right side, got the first down. Oh. Look out, he's got more, 30, 25, 20, to the 15. Chased down by Franklin, and he is into the end zone. It is touchdown time in Texas. 9:07 on the clock, and Hawthorne just broke one. 38 yards. We keep talking about Hawthorne. At some point, he's going to break one. And look out, Mama, he got you.
Yeah, he sure did. He was met at the line of scrimmage. Matter of fact, he was hit twice at the line of scrimmage. And, Anthony's just hard to bring down if you don't wrap him up.
Honaker now on for this tying PAT. Easton Ross to hold. The snap is back. It's good. It's on the tee. The kick is up. It looks like it's good. And it is. And we have a tie ball game here at Jackie Hendricks Stadium with 9:07 left to go in the second quarter. 14-14 back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
GCEC Wireless, located in Van Alstine off of Exit 51, can help you with all your Verizon wireless needs. They have a wide range of products and services, including smartphones, wireless home and mobile internet, wireless home phone service, and accessories. They're also your local DirecTV dealer. So come on by or call them at 903-712-2355. That's GCEC Wireless. And go Bulldogs!
Think back to the best fried pie you've ever had. It won't compare to Sweetie Pies in Van Alstine. They have handmade apricot, apple, peach, buttermilk, chocolate, coconut, and lemon fried pies that melt in your mouth. Located at 120 South Main Street in Van Alstine on the east side of downtown. Give them a call at 903-712-PIES. That's 903-712-7437. Sweetie Pies can also make custom Howe cookies, muffins, and other baked goods.
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier and the rest of the gang. Here's going to be a squib kick again by Howe. Onside kick going to be taken at the 48-yard line And Cooper will recover there, and it looks like on the ball for Cooper is going to be Justin Gibson. And they will start from their own 48-yard line. And there is 9:07 on the second quarter clock. It was a 38-yard touchdown by Anthony Hawthorne, which capped off a 59-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 46 seconds off the clock. And Hawthorne, we talked about at some point, he will bust one, and he did. First and 10 for Cooper from their own 48-yard line. And whistles will blow before we get underway. I think a timeout's been called, and it has. We'll take one, too. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
It's way too hot for your vehicle's AC to go out. Head over to 4A Automotive and Howe for their special air conditioning service checkup for just $39.95. For over 10 years, they've provided the most reliable and dependable service and repairs in the area. 4A Automotive is a bumper-to-bumper service shop. They do it all, from autos to diesels, and they're front-end specialists, too. So call 4A Automotive today at 903-546-0024. They're located 4 miles east of Howe at the corner of FM 902 and Luella Road.
Calling all Bulldog fans to come down to the Sonic and Howe for half-price shakes after 8 and open until midnight, home games only, where you get great food and big smiles. And a little message for all our Howe football players, go Bulldogs fight, Bulldogs win, win, win. Because it's not just good, it's Sonic good.
Welcome back as Cooper on first down tossed it right side to Jones, I believe. But a flag was that, Franklin rather, and a flag was down as soon as the ball was snapped. So that's going to be against Cooper. Wolf.
Jacob Taylor made a stop for the Bulldogs.
We'll back him up 5 yards. Actually, no, that's it's against Howe. Well, we'll see. Yeah, it's against Howe. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. So offsides against Howe there.
I think the end on this side may have been offsides.
First and 5 now for Cooper. Now in Howe territory at the 47-yard line. 8:50 on the clock and rolling. Here in the second quarter, we have a tie ball game in this Bi-District Classic. Turning out to be that way early anyway. Here's Franklin with the toss right up the middle. He's got some room, busts through to the 35, inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. And Franklin, once he gets the football, he just moves forward, doesn't stop.
And Dalton Felder, Andrew Griffin, Levi Marinsky in on the stop.
It'll be a first down for Cooper at the 34-yard line. And it looks like the decision to defer the coin toss may come in handy for the Bulldogs as this may be a seesaw type of football game. First and 10. McGraw under center, toss right side. Franklin runs it straight up the gut again. And he'll gain 2, maybe 3, maybe even 4 to the 30-yard line as they toss it as if they're going to run to the right side. But Franklin does not run to the right side. He runs straight behind the center after he gets the toss.
Yeah, he takes just a little bit of a hesitant step there, and then right up the middle. Tackle was made by Charlie Overby.
So it'll be second down and 6 for Cooper. Moving left to right, McGraw under center. And he will toss left side this time to Franklin, and he will be stopped shy of the first down to the 27-yard line. Gain of about 2 or 3 for Cooper, and it'll be third down.
Dalton Felder, Tyler Grisham in on the stop.
Ball is at the 27-yard line. Cooper's needing to get to the 24 for a first down. Bringing in the play for Cooper is Ryan Longshore, and he'll split out wide left up at the top. He'll be covered by Easton Ross on the far side. This will be a toss left side. Franklin cuts it back to the middle, and the flag's down. He's right now he has enough for the first down, but we'll check the flag and see what that's going to be. The officials are discussing it. It's going to be a chop block against Cooper, so another big penalty there. Still, Cooper has had big penalties in this football game, and one finally did cost him earlier in that last Howe drive, a defensive penalty, and we'll see what this offensive penalty does, as Franklin would have had a first down there, but this will not be a first down. This will actually be a pretty big penalty. We'll see where they mark it and spot it. Right now, the first down would have been at the 24-yard line.
So it's going to be third down and 18.
They're going to move the ball way on back to the 42-yard line. That is a huge, huge penalty against the Cooper Bulldogs. Massive, in fact.
Yeah, that's that penalty, you know, it's one that hurts you.
So it'll be third and 18 now for Cooper. Instead of a first down. That's pretty significant. Split out wide to the top is Hadley Warden. As McGraw wants to throw the football down the field. Has a man, and it's almost intercepted by Hawthorne. Hawthorne leaped in front of the receiver. It was Tanner Pfeiffer who was the intended receiver, 5'10", 175 senior. Hawthorne jumped it, had it in his chest for a moment, but it fell right out. It'll be fourth down and 18 now for Cooper.
Yeah, and as you could tell, the Cooper fans weren't very happy with that one. They wanted a flag, and I don't know. I just don't see it.
The looks like the punt team will come in for the Cooper Bulldogs, and quarterback Jaden McGraw is also the punter, and he will now step back at the 46-yard line, past midfield, and he will punt this one away. A low wobbly kick, going to bounce and take a Howe roll initially, and now turns the other way and goes towards the 12-yard line, and that's where Howe will start after Cooper's first punt of the night. So with 6:13 on the clock, Howe gets the football back, but trapped deep in their own territory at their own 12.
Looks like there's a good one in Roy City tonight. S&S and Lone Oak are tied 7-7, 10-15 left in the second.
So almost a three-minute drive by Cooper ends up with nothing. And we'll see what Howe can do now, as it looks like Wall will go under center. And he's going to keep it up the middle. That's actually Lopez. And he's got the 20 to the 22 and a first down after a 10-yard, 11-yard run on the quarterback keeper right over the right side. Ball will be spotted at the 23. 6:06 on the second quarter clock. Tied up 14-14.
Hadley Warden made the stop.
So a fresh set of downs after that first down carry. And at some point you think, you know, Lopez, who did have the 97-yard run against Whiteright on that same quarterback keeper, Coach Dale West was hoping for the same results right there. Here's an end-around reverse to Brandon Wall, and this is the play that Stratton Carroll made so famous around Bulldog Stadium. But Wall will only gain 5 yards there up to the 28-yard line.
Warden again in on the stop for Cooper.
5:32 on the clock. Tied up 14-14. Quentin Harris will bring the play in for the Howe Bulldogs. Hartsfield comes to the line of scrimmage. Two men in the backfield. Tyler Grisham is going to get the carry, left guard, and he bangs his way forward to a first down. Gain of about 6 up to the 34-yard line.
Colton Strode made the stop for the Bulldogs.
A very different plan of attack for offensive coordinator Dale West this week as opposed to last week, where it was all Hawthorne with 30 carries and 206 yards. This time around, this week, it's a little bit different as Tyler Grisham getting a few carries. And Brandon Wall had a carry, and Joaquin Lopez kind of spreading it around a little bit more, and I think that's key because when Howe has two rushers go over 100 yards, they're 5-0 this year.
Yeah.
Hawthorne in motion, and this will be a carry to the near side, and that'll be Brandon Wall, and he'll gain 1, maybe 2 yards. They actually usually run, when Hawthorne goes in motion, they usually hand it to him like that. It's the first time I've seen them fake the hand to him and give it on the reverse on the trap coming back to the near side. It'll be second down and 8 after the 2 yard run.
And Tanner Pfeiffer made the stop for the Bulldogs.
Ball will now rest at the 37 in Howe territory with 4:24 on the clock. Everybody comes to the line of scrimmage in a hurry. Lopez, handoff Tyler Grisham, left side, looking for some room, picking and choosing some holes, and finally met and brought down at the 44-yard line. You know, about a yard shy of the first down.
Colby Early made the end on the stop for the Bulldogs. You know, we talk about Tyler all the time. You know, Tyler, you get what you get sometimes with Tyler. Tyler gets a burst of energy where he's going to run over you, but then he gets that point to where he makes 5, 10, 11, 12 yards, just kind of picking his holes and you know, short, choppy stepping it.
Third and 1. Grisham, again, same play. Got the first down. Crosses the 46-yard line. So Howe is doing what they do, is starting this long drive, chewing up a lot of clock, keeping the other team off the field. That's exactly what the Howe Bulldogs want to do.
You know, and that's what they do best. You know, when they do this type and they chew this clock, they do well.
If the Bulldogs could score here and then get the ball back to start the second half, that would be huge. There's going to be Hawthorne on that reverse in motion, and I believe he fumbled the football, and he did, but it's going to be recovered in the backfield. I believe that's Lopez who got back on the football. Lopez recovered it, thankfully, as
Zach Jester made the initial hit that popped the ball loose.
And that'll be a big loss all the way back to the 41-yard line. About a 5-yard loss, 6-yard loss. So now Howe faces that long second down and 16 situation. Lopez wants to throw the football, throws a swing pass out to Grisham, who's met immediately. He does catch the ball, but it's only good for maybe a yard, or he got back to the line of scrimmage, rather. So third down and 16.
Tanner Pfeiffer met him immediately.
It looked like for a moment that Lopez had a receiver downfield wide open, but he chose to hit the swing route, and he was hit by Pfeiffer immediately, and it'll be third and 16 with 2:13 on the clock. Moving right to left, Brandon Wall under center. And they'll give it to Hawthorne, right side, looking for some room. He's got some room and fell down at just short of the 50. Tripped up at the 50-yard line. So it'll be fourth down now and about 7 or 8 yards, as Hawthorne had a good run there. Timeout's been called. We will take 1-2. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
You're invited to the one and only Buck Snort Barbecue in downtown Van Alstine, Texas. Your friends and neighbors say it's the best barbecue in North Texas. Now it's your turn to decide. Come taste the difference at Buck Snort Barbecue. For complete store information, including menu, location, and hours, click on BuckSnortBarbecue.com. That's BuckSnortBBQ.com. Buck Snort Barbecue in downtown Van Alstine is a proud supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
Welcome back, as both teams coming back on the field now after that quick timeout. This is a huge play for the Howe Bulldogs. 4th and 7. The ball is right at midfield. And it looks like they're going to punt it away. Overby's back to punt this one away. You know, Howe loves to go for it, but this one just a little bit too risky in this situation. No wind tonight, so it should be a pretty good punt. Nice snap, and Overby's low spiraling punt's going to bounce at the 22, take a good Howe roll inside the 15, and finally roll dead at about the 13-yard line. So Cooper will have 1 minute 44 seconds left before half to try to score from their own 13.
You know, that we say a lot, about the Bulldogs, but you know they have a lot that they can choose from. There's a lot of different options in that offense and defense.
Yeah, and I'm a little bit concerned about how Franklin just. He shoots that gap very hard, very fast, and he's going to get a lot of opportunity right here. Here's McGraw. He's going to toss left side. There's Franklin looking for the outside edge. Got the 12, cuts past the 15, up near the 20-yard line, and slammed out of bounds by Hawthorne. Hawthorne and Franklin have met twice tonight, and Hawthorne has done all of the damage so far.
Yeah.
Got to be very close. He was close to a late hit, though, I believe.
It was pretty close there.
It'll be second down and 5 as they'll spot the ball at the 19-yard line. 1:36 on the clock as Franklin did get out of bounds to stop the clock. And now Cooper will come back and bring, looks like it'll be Ryan Longshore bringing the play in. He'll be split out wide left. McGraw under center, a double wing to the near side. Franklin in the backfield. And they will fake it to him. McGraw wants to throw the football. All kinds of pressure in his face. It is intercepted!
Tyler Grisham.
Grisham picks it off at the 12-yard line. And Howe's in great shape to score with 1:29 left to go before the half.
And Tyler was in. He just kind of right there in that right spot at the right time.
What a tremendous job by Grisham of jumping that route. And it was, I think you can thank Jacob Taylor because he was in the face of McGraw. And McGraw just had to get rid of it because Taylor was right there in his face. And here comes Lopez under center. They're going to give to Grisham, left side. And not much doing there. Maybe a yard to the 11-yard. Maybe, yeah, 1 yard to the 11. So 1:21 and rolling here. Howe is well within field goal range for the freshman, Bryce Honaker.
Yeah.
And it would be huge for Howe to take a lead here, knowing that they're going to get the football back coming out in the second half. This is going to be Lopez keeping it on the right side. Makes a man miss, cuts it past the 10 to the 9-yard line. Gain of a couple. It'll be third and long. A timeout has been taken with 55 seconds. We'll keep it right here.
Hadley Ward made the stop for Cooper.
You know, we're getting in a situation here with a 3rd and 7 outlook on this upcoming play. But Honaker, let's say they don't gain any yards here. It would be a 26-yard field goal attempt by Honaker from this moment. But we'll see what they do on his third down play. Obviously, you'd like to see, if you're a Howe fan, just punch it in right here and not have to worry about any of that.
Yeah. Was watching. Looked like Coach Hudson may be a little upset with someone. Refresh his screen here. S&S and Lone Oak. Lone Oak's up on S&S 14-13.
Wow, that's closer than what I thought.
With 3:43 left in the second. Let's see here. Got to go back a district to get anyone else.
Well, that's the main one.
Yeah, because Gunner played last night. Leonard played last night. So that's our main thing for tonight's Lone Oak S&S.
I'm just shocked that it's that close. Here comes the Bulldogs. Lopez under center. One man in the backfield is Hawthorne. Sends a man in motion to Wall, and Hawthorne gets it left guard. He bangs his way past the 5 to the 4 to the 3. Still fighting, still pushing. And he's going to be very close to a first down. Clock still rolling at 42, 41, and now the clock has stopped. Going to be close to a first down. We'll see. I think they are going to either measure. It's going to be a yard short. Huh? They might measure. Well, no, Howe has called a timeout. We'll keep it right here. Fourth down.
Yeah.
What do you do here?
I don't know.
I think you've got to kick it if you've got the freshman kicker. But, man, I tell you, that's not an easy place to put a freshman kicker in a playoff game to take the lead before the half. I mean, what kind of pressure is that for a 15-year-old?
Yeah.
14-year-old.
Yeah, that's pretty tough. You know, he is – He is perfect, or pretty close.
He's had
one after. He's missed one, hasn't he?
He missed a 47-yarder, attempted a game winner last week, and missed another one early on in the season.
But still, that's a lot of pressure.
He has hit a 37-yarder this year.
You know, but you, we talk about Bryce. He could possibly make it. That's a lot of pressure.
It would be an extra point is basically what it would be.
Right.
It would be exactly an extra point, which is a 20-yard field goal. But Howe is not going to do that. It's fourth and one. They're not going to kick it. They're going to go for it. On fourth and one, man in motion. Handoff. Hawthorne, right side. He's in. It is touchdown time in Texas. What a call. That's one of those that you're great if you make it. You're dumb if you don't. And Coach Hudson proves to be very, very smart on that play.
And that was a big hole there on that right side.
36 seconds left to go before the half, and Hawthorne punches it in from 2 yards out.
You know, we talk a lot about Bryce, and we talk a lot about Easton. Easton's a holder and Honker the kicker, but, you know, we can't forget guy getting that ball back there, Caleb Ake. He's a senior this year. He gets that ball back there pretty good every time, too.
Honaker on for this important PAT. Easton Ross is on the tee. The kick is up, and the kick is good. 21-14, Howe in the lead with 36 seconds left to go before the half. We will be back in just a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
The Howe Athletic Booster Club invites you to become a supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
And the type of kids we have, they're just hard workers and do anything you ask.
Memberships are $25 and will be available at all home games. All proceeds benefit high school and middle school athletic programs. Please join the Howe Athletic Booster Club in our efforts to support our hometown kids.
When people come here, you know, it's something they can be proud of.
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier and Stephen Braswell, the freezing Stephen Braswell, standing outside tonight, doing our spotting through the window as the Howe Bulldogs have just scored. Hawthorne takes it in from 2 yards out, and Howe has a 21-14 lead at the moment with 36 seconds left to go before the half. You know, Howe has done the onside kick here all night long. I think you probably want to kick this one deep, and it is going to be a deep kick to the near side. It does go out of bounds at the 23-yard line, so that'll be a flag. We'll see what happens there. We'll see if Cooper decides to re-kick or whether they will just take the yards on the penalty. There's 36 seconds on the clock.
So, if you're Cooper, what do you do here?
Well, I would think you just have to take a knee here. But, we'll see what they do. Here's McGraw, sends a man in motion, and they're not going to take a knee. Jones is going to carry it to the left side, and he's tripped up in the backfield, a loss of two. And now we'll see what they do as there's 29 seconds on the clock.
Freshman Andrew Griffin, 5'9", 180 pounds, tripped up the big guy. Looks like he may have even lost a yard or two.
There's only 14 seconds on the clock and rolling here, so this will be the last play of the first half. Howe leading 21-14, 5-4-3. They get it off, toss right side. Jones, and he's met and brought down at the 30-yard line, and we are at halftime. And Howe's leading 21-14 here after the first half, and lots of happy Howe Bulldogs on the far sideline as they go into the locker room with a lead, 21-14. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
The Howe Enterprise has served Howe as the hometown news since 1963. Since then, the Bulldogs have won 8 district, 7 by-district, 3 area championships, and 1 regional title. We've seen 14 different head coaches during that time. The Howe Enterprise has been with the Bulldogs for 51 years. We were there when the Pride of Howe won 3 band state championships. HoweEnterprise.com publishes weekly on Mondays.
Carrie's Coffee Company in historic downtown Van Alstine, next to the post office, is the new upscale coffee shop serving Van Alstine, Howe, and surrounding areas. Carrie's Coffee Company offers a wide variety of organic coffee and non-coffee beverages and baked goods. Come visit Carrie's Coffee Company in downtown Van Alstine, next to the post office, and mention this ad and get 50% off your first beverage. Open Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 2 p.m. and 7 a.m. on Saturdays. Carrie's Coffee Company is Texas quality.
Your business has a story to tell. Let Fast Signs help you tell it using the right mix of visual communication solutions like signs, banners, digital displays, vehicle graphics, mobile marketing, and so much more. Give Fast Signs your business challenge and we'll come up with a plan to grow your business, reach more customers, and accomplish more than you ever thought possible. Fast Signs, more than fast, more than signs.
Fast Signs Texoma, located at 1916 North Grand Avenue in Sherman, 903-893-SIGN.
Hi, this is Chris Cavender. The holidays are around the corner. Call Cavender Home Theater to get that new TV or audio system delivered and set up by our professionals. We can deliver all that plus dish with one visit by our top-notch team of installers so you know it's done right. Competitive prices, local service you can depend on. Come see us at 6202 Texoma Parkway in Sherman, online at CavenderHT.com, or give us a call, 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium in Princeton, Texas. Monty Walker along with Stratton Carroll. Welcome Stratton to the booth. What an unfortunate incident for you and a bad way to end the season. Talk about that. And how did it exactly happen? Do you remember the play?
Yes, I was. We're doing a little reverse, and the lineman cut, and I tried to jump over them. And when I landed, a guy took my knees out. It didn't feel too good, but.
Yeah, I know exactly how that feels. I did that my junior year as well, and it's not an easy recovery. And how'd the surgery go?
The surgery went good. The doctor said everything went good, and on the road to rehab and recovery.
Who was the doctor?
Dr. Cooper.
Okay. Carroll Clinic?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and the surgery was when?
It was yesterday.
Wow, so that's a pretty quick turnabout here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so I guess nothing can keep you away from a playoff game, huh?
No, sir. I wanted to come out here and watch my boys.
Yeah, now talk about the team here what are your impressions so far the first half?
I think we're running the ball good. We're getting good pushes. Our defense is getting better. They struggled first possession or so, but they're going to come back and they're going to wear them out.
Now you're a part of this team, and you know exactly what's going on in the locker room right now. Who's doing the talking, and what are they talking about?
Probably Coach West is yelling at the linemen right now. But I think they'll come out and they'll do better this half.
And as far as Coach Hudson, what kind of coach is he?
He's a great coach. He knows how to motivate us and put us where we need to be and to make the plays.
Who's been you've got a new offense this year, and that was a big change, I'm sure, for all of y'all. Talk about that and how you had to deal with that.
Coach West came in and he really took over on the offense side, and I think he did. He's doing really good on teaching us. It was pretty difficult to learn at first, but I think we're getting the hang of it, and we're doing good now.
What kind of adjustments did you have to make, and what kind of offense was it last year?
Last year we started out in spread, but towards the end of the season, we changed to more of a running style offense, but nothing like it is now. It's more up the middle, and I think it's a better offense.
Who's the vocal leader on this team?
I'd have to say Anthony and Joaquin. They lead us pretty good.
And this team more than any other team I think I've ever seen, is chalked full of sophomores and freshmen.
Yes, we're a young team.
How did they blend in, and have they blended nicely with the, with the team?
They came in here, and they've been playing just like us. You know, they haven't been making rookie mistakes, really. I mean, at first they were, but they've grown up a lot.
How hard is it for you to watch this up here?
It's pretty difficult. I'd much rather be down there playing, obviously.
I guess you're on some pretty good meds right now.
Yes, I am. I'm not in too much pain.
Yeah. All right. Well, we appreciate you coming up here and wish you the best of luck and do the rehab.
Yes.
You've got to do the rehab. I had surgery in February. And I was in 2 days in August. Now, that's pretty tough, but you can do it. It can be done. But I know the I understand yours was a little bit more difficult as you had some MCL work, too.
MCL meniscus repair. So
along with the ACL?
I will be back in June.
Okay.
Fully. I mean, I can do start jogging and stuff about 3-4 months, but come back competitive probably 6 months.
No dancing at the prom, huh?
Brad, to slow myself down there.
All right, Stratton, I sure appreciate it. Thanks for coming on with us on the broadcast. We're going to take a quick timeout. That was Stratton Carroll, who has his 896 yards up here in the press box. We'll be back in a moment with more Howe Bulldogs football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Abby's Restaurant is family-owned and run. They have the cure for all your home cooking cravings. Chicken fried steak, loaded baked potato, bacon patty melt, grilled chicken salad, cheese fries, jalapeno stuffed peppers, and more. Don't forget to save room for that cheesecake and cobbler with ice cream. We know you're going to love the food and the service. Abby's Restaurant in downtown Howe. They're open from 11 to 8, Monday through Saturday. Give them a call, 903-487-8860. Abby's Restaurant.
The Bulldogs make the playoffs and you get the payoff. Hi, this is Chris with Cavender Home Theater. Through November, we're going to give you a $100 Visa gift card just for signing up for Dish with Cavender Home Theater. That's on top of $400 in discounts and free installation. So get the hopper with the best DVR, more HD channels, commercial skip on recorded primetime shows, and lots of apps like Sports Finder and TV Anywhere. Upgrade your home and save money. Visit us at CavenderTV.com or call us at 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
For my family, life is a series of celebrations, from my newest born cousin to my grandmother. We all partake in births, weddings, and funerals. Wherever we celebrate, we need to feel welcome. That's why we choose Scoggins Funeral Home and Howe. Scoggins Funeral Home understands our needs. Talk to the caring staff at Scoggins Funeral Home. Call 903-532-5577 or visit ScogginsFuneralHome.com.
GCEC Wireless, located in Van Alstine off of Exit 51, can help you with all your Verizon wireless needs. They have a wide range of products and services, including smartphones, wireless home and mobile internet, wireless home phone service, and accessories. They're also your local DirecTV dealer. So come on by or call them at 903-712-2355. That's GCEC Wireless. And go Bulldogs!
Think back to the best fried pie you've ever had. It won't compare to Sweetie Pies in Van Alstine. They have handmade apricot, apple, peach, buttermilk, chocolate, coconut, and lemon fried pies that melt in your mouth. Located at 120 South Main Street in Van Alstine on the east side of downtown. Give them a call at 903-712-PIES. That's 903-712-7437. Sweetie Pies can also make custom Howe cookies, muffins, and other baked goods.
It's way too hot for your vehicle's AC to go out. Head over to 4A Automotive in Howe for their special air conditioning service checkup for just $39.95. For over 10 years, they've provided the most reliable and dependable service and repairs in the area. 4A Automotive is a bumper-to-bumper service shop. They do it all, from autos to diesels, and they're front-end specialists, too. So call 4A Automotive today at 903-546-0024. They're located 4 miles east of Howe at the corner of FM 902 and Luella Road.
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium in Princeton. Let's go over some halftime stats. Rushing for the Howe Bulldogs, Anthony Hawthorne has 16 carries, 77 yards at the half with two touchdowns. Next on the list is Tyler Grisham with 8 carries, 62 yards, and 1 touchdown. He's averaging 7.75 yards per carry. He also has 1 reception for no yards and an interception. So Tyler Grisham is by far your first half player of the game for the Howe Bulldogs. Over on the Cooper side, Jaden McCraw, 1 out of 3 passing for 11 yards. He also has that interception to Tyler Grisham. Rushing, Ira Franklin, 11 carries, 97 yards. That's good for 8.81 a carry. His longest so far this evening is a 27-yarder. But Tristan Jones has scored all of the points for the Cooper Bulldogs. 8 carries, 60 yards, 2 touchdowns, and a 2-point conversion. His longest carry of the night, 18 yards. Receiving on the night for the Cooper Bulldogs, only 1 catch. That's Dolly Warner, 1 reception for 11 yards. And we are just about ready for the second half. In just a few moments, the teams are still in the dressing room. And it was an interesting conversation we had with Stratton Carroll. And you just hate that for that young man. He's in good spirits, you know, but it's got to be hard. At least my ACL tear my junior year came in basketball season.
Yeah.
You know, that would have been really hard to miss the playoffs.
It is, and, you know, you could tell he didn't want to be up here. You know, I was glad we had the opportunity to talk to him, but he'll be back, and he's going to be. I know Stratton, known Stratton for a while. Him and Bryce played baseball together. They've played football together. They've been friends for a couple of years, and Stratton's going to come back just as strong as he was this year. He's going to be ready to play come August.
The Howe Bulldogs are making their way out of the dressing room onto the back of the end zone, now doing their stretching. And before long, they will have the football to start the second half as they deferred when they won the toss to open the football game. Let's go for some playoff records for the Howe Bulldogs. Overall playoff record, 9-15-3. Those 3 ties, 2 of them advanced in the playoffs, 1 against Salina, and the very next week tied Alney 10-10, advanced both games, 1 on penetrations and once on first downs against Alney. The most playoff games in a year that any Bulldog team has played has been 3 games, 1985, 1989, and 1990, all played 3 playoff games in those years. The most points ever scored by Howe in a playoff game is 28. We're sitting right now at 21 for Howe. Could very well break that mark tonight. Most points given up in a game, 46. That was back in 1940 versus Louisville. Louisville.
Louisville.
Louisville.
Wow. That was a long time ago.
The last time shut out by an opponent. That's not going to happen tonight. That was back in 2010 against New Boston, 35-0. The last time Howe shut out an opponent, which will also not happen tonight, was back in 1985. That was against Grand Saline, 18-0. All 9 wins have been against 9 different opponents, and if Howe wins tonight, make it 10. It would be 10 different opponents because Howe's never faced Cooper in the playoffs. The most rushing yards in a game, 272. Clint Bray did that against Roy City, and right now Anthony Hawthorne has 77. He's got a long way to go to catch Clint Bray from that night. The most rushing touchdowns in a game, 4. That was Nathaniel Falls against Denton in that classic, which was the number 1 most exciting playoff game in school history, according to HowEnterprise.com. Most passing yards in a game, that will not happen tonight. That was 196 by Clint Grogan versus Boyd in 1998, and a lot of that came on one play, the longest receiving touchdown, which was 81 yards by Heath Horton in that game.
Heath Horton.
Most passing touchdowns in a game was 3. That was Jay Skipworth versus Roy City in 1989. Interesting trivia about Roy City and Howe in that 1989 game. Do you know where that playoff game was held?
No.
In Bulldog Stadium. The bi-district playoff game was held at Bulldog Stadium because Roy City wanted to play in Garland, and they would not come off of that and meet at a neutral site. So Howe, Coach Jim Fryer and Billy Hill said, okay, you flip for Garland, we're going to flip for Howe. And we all know what happened. Howe won that coin toss and played the five district games in Howe, Texas.
That's pretty interesting.
The passing completion percentage in a game is held by Rick Haining in 1970 versus Lone Oak. 69.23 completion percentage. He was 9 out of 13 that night. The longest rushing touchdown in the playoffs, 80 yards by Stephen Ogle versus Pilot Point in 1986. The longest field goal in a playoff game was 35 yards, done twice. Stephen Hawthorne versus Electra in 1989 and Charlie Komorowski versus Farmersville in 2000. The most wins by a head coach is 4, Jim Fryer. He also has the most losses by a head coach, also 4. Most playoff games started by a player, 7 by Monty Walker and John Norwood. Hey, how about that?
Look at that.
I got something.
There you go.
Most overall playoff points scored, 42 by Stephen Ogle in 85 and 86. The most overall touchdowns, 7, Stephen Ogle, 85 and 86. Most overall rushing touchdowns, 7, Stephen Ogle, 85-86. Sound familiar?
Yep.
Most overall passing touchdowns, 3 by Jay Skipworth in 89. And most overall point after attempts, Micah Henderson in 2003. And the most overall field goals, each had 1, Stephen Hawthorne, Monty Walker, Charlie Komorowski, and Mark Wheeler in 1985. We're going to take a quick timeout. We'll be back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
The Howe Athletic Booster Club invites you to become a supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
And the type of kids we have, they're just hard workers and do anything you ask.
Memberships are $25 and will be available at all home games. All proceeds benefit high school and middle school athletic programs. Please join the Howe Athletic Booster Club in our efforts to support our hometown kids.
When people come here, you know, it's something they can be proud of.
The Howe Enterprise has served Howe as the hometown news since 1963. Since then, the Bulldogs have won 8 district, 7 by-district, 3 area championships, and 1 regional title. We've seen 14 different head coaches during that time. The Howe Enterprise has been with the Bulldogs for 51 years. We were there when the pride of Howe won 3 band state championships. HoweEnterprise.com publishes weekly on Mondays.
Carrie's Coffee Company in historic downtown Van Alstine, next to the post office, is the new upscale coffee shop serving Van Alstine, Howe, and surrounding areas. Carrie's Coffee Company offers a wide variety of organic coffee and non-coffee beverages and baked goods. Come visit Carrie's Coffee Company in downtown Van Alstine, next to the post office, and mention this ad and get 50% off your first beverage. Open Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 2 p.m. and 7 a.m. on Saturdays. Carrie's Coffee Company is Texas quality.
Here come the Howe Bulldogs. We are about to begin the second half here at Jackie Hendrick Stadium in Princeton, Texas, where Howe leads 21-14 and are about to get the football to start the second half. Again, Howe won the coin toss to begin the football game and elected to defer. Cooper took the ball first, and Cooper actually started this football game on top on that first possession, 6-0 after a Tristan Jones 14-yard touchdown run. Howe got the ball back and punted for the first time on their first drive. Cooper took it and fumbled by Franklin. It was Merzinski who picked it up. Howe got the football back. Tyler Grisham scored moments later on a 15-yard touchdown run. And Howe had a 7-6 lead with 2:38 left to go in the first quarter. And then Cooper came right back. And Tristan Jones scored for the second time tonight, this one from 5 yards out. He also scored on the two-point conversion to give Cooper the 14-7 lead. And then Anthony Hawthorne broke free from 38 yards to score to tie the football game at 14. And then later, Hawthorne would score again from 2 yards out with 36 seconds left to go before the half after a Tyler Grisham interception to set up that touchdown. And now Mr. Hawthorne is back deep, ready to receive this kick. It's going to be a squib kick. Hawthorne will take it at the 14-yard line, going right side with some room up to the 40, up to the 45, up to the 50. He breaks free to the 40. Look out to the 30 and down inside Cooper territory to the 28-yard line. And once Anthony Hawthorne has the football in his hands and open space, he can go at any moment. And he almost did right there.
Yeah, Brandon Toon made the stop for Cooper.
So already Howe knocking on the door inside the 30 at the 28-yard line to set up shop here on the nice kick return by Hawthorne. So Howe again in Cooper territory. So this will be an I formation, handoff. Hawthorne, good for about 3 yards to the 25-yard line. Wall was at quarterback to start the second half, and Joaquin Lopez moved to fullback. We talked to Coach West before the game, and he said look out for that may happen quite a bit. They'll run that I formation with Wall at quarterback and Lopez at fullback, and Anthony Hawthorne dots the I.
Tristan.
We're going to run that again here. Hand off Hawthorne again, right side. Met hard at the line of scrimmage, brought down maybe a gain of one.
Colby Early in on the stop for Cooper.
21-14. Howe in the lead with 11:06 in the third quarter. We're just underway. And Howe's facing a third and five as Hawthorne ran the kick return all the way down into Cooper territory. And here's Howe at the 24. Lopez under center, sends a man in motion. He'll toss to him. And on the reverse, Hawthorne gets it. He actually wanted to throw the football for a moment. Now he escapes the defender. He's got the 25-20 to the 15 and out of bounds right at the 15-yard line. Now a late flag way back has been tossed. That flag was thrown about 40 feet in the air.
Yeah.
Wow, there was no tackle. It looked like
we'll see what happens here. It's against Cooper. Personal foul against the Cooper Bulldogs, and that's another huge penalty against Cooper. We'll see what this one does as far as dividends for the Howe Bulldogs, but that is a huge, huge penalty. It'll spot the ball right at the 7.5, halfway to the goal.
Yeah, it looked like it.
You almost wish that Hawthorne would have stepped out at the 16.
It looked like Clay Ingram is the guy they called it on.
If Hawthorne stepped out at the 16, Howe would have it at the 1. However, he stepped out at the 15, and it's halfway to the goal. Ball's at the 7. Handoff, Hawthorne. Now that's Grisham to the right side, and he scoops his way inside the 5 to the 4 to the 3-yard line. They'll actually say his knee hit at the 4, so it'll be 2nd and goal from the 4.
Ira Franklin in on the stop for the Bulldogs.
10:17 on the third quarter clock. Howe already leading 21-14. The most points Howe's ever scored in a playoff game is 28. And they're looking for that right here. Ball in between the 4 and the 5. Hartsfield, Lopez under center, will hand it off on the reverse to Wall. Coming near side. He's close. He is in. It is touchdown time in Texas. Brandon Wall on the touchdown, his 2nd of the year, this one from 4 yards out. And Howe extends the lead 27-14 with 9:54 in the third quarter awaiting this PAT. That is the play that Stratton Carroll scored on many, many times this year. And Brandon Wall takes over that play and makes it his own on that one.
Yes, he did.
So Honaker with Easton Ross will hold, trying to tie the most points in school history in a playoff game, and he's not going to do it. This was a low kick that was, I think it might have been blocked partially by Jones, and it was. So Howe has a 27-14 lead here in the third quarter with 9:54 on the clock. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Your business has a story to tell. Let Fast Signs help you tell it using the right mix of visual communication solutions like signs, banners, digital displays, vehicle graphics, mobile marketing, and so much more. Give Fast Signs your business challenge and we'll come up with a plan to grow your business, reach more customers, and accomplish more than you ever thought possible. Fast Signs. More than fast, more than signs.
Fast Signs Texoma, located at 1916 North Grand Avenue in Sherman. 903-893-SIGN.
Hi, this is Chris Cavender. The holidays are around the corner. Call Cavender Home Theater to get that new TV or audio system delivered and set up by our professionals. We can deliver all that plus dish with one visit by our top-notch team of installers so you know it's done right. Competitive prices, local service you can depend on. Come see us at 6202 Texoma Parkway in Sherman, online at CavenderHT.com, or give us a call 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
Abby's Howe has recovered the football on the kick at the 22-yard line. It was a deep pooch kick that Ira Franklin could not handle.
Tyler Grisham he came up with the fumble.
Franklin had the ball. He caught it initially and then dropped it. The ball kept rolling around. He had possession of it, I thought, for a moment, and then the ball slipped free again. And right there, Grisham, was it Grisham on the recovery?
Yes, yes.
What a game Tyler Grisham is having as he recovers the fumble. And now Howe's in great shape. Hawthorne in motion. He gets the hand coming right side looking for a block from Grisham. And he gets it for a moment. He actually didn't, but Hawthorne makes his own block and runs right over the defender for about 5 yards on the carry.
And Dally Warner in on the stop.
So Grisham with the fumble recovery. He has an interception and a touchdown tonight. Playing for the first... His dad said that this is the first time a Grisham has played in a playoff game since the 1970s. It'll be second down and six, or a long five, rather.
He's playing a good ball game.
Handoff, Grisham, right side, and he's going to be close to a first down, just a little bit short at the 16-yard line.
Colby Early and Dally Warner in on the stop.
So here is Howe on a third down and two situation, and you know this is four down territory. Hawthorne alone in the backfield with two slots, and Wall will go in motion. Hawthorne will get the carry on a big hole to the right side, and he bangs his way down to the 5 yard line and a fumble. There's a fumble in the end zone, and I think it goes out of the end zone. No, Cooper has recovered in the end zone. Oh, no.
Ira Franklin come up with a ball for Cooper.
Wow. So now, Cooper will have the ball at the 20. With 8:22, boy, you thought just for a moment Howe was just about to create some huge separation in this football game. But not going to happen right now anyway, as Cooper will take over at their own 20. 8:22 on the clock. Howe leading 27-14. This is going to be a toss right side. McGraw is going to toss to Franklin. He's got some room. 25-30. 35-40. It steps out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Franklin, the 6'2", 180, tall, slender frame, is very fast. And he just gained a lot of yardage right there up to the 42.
Yeah, Levi Marinsky run him out of bounds.
So 8:14 on the third quarter clock. And, boy, that's a game changer of a fumble. Here's Franklin on the left side. And he will spin out of a tackle and gain 5 yards to the 48.
Dalton Felder made the stop for the Bulldogs.
It was a 22-yard run on first down for Franklin, who actually recovered the fumble, which is good for him because he's the one who fumbled to gave it to Howe in the first place. So I guess he's kind of even right now here in the second half. Second down and five, just shy of midfield is Cooper, moving left to right. This is McGraw, right side to Franklin again, looking for a block, has a block. He's got the 45, 40, and still keeps his feet somehow to the 34-yard line.
And run out of bounds. Run out of bounds by Levi Marinsky.
Yeah, when Marzinski makes the tackle, you know it's not a good thing for Howe because safeties usually make the tackle way down the field.
Right.
So it'll be first and 10 for Cooper as they're moving now with Ira Franklin just at will on that toss sweep. First and 10, 7:12 on the third quarter clock. Wing formation, the toss left side. Jones into the game, and he leaps over one defender to the 35, to the 30, gets the edge and pushed out of bounds at the 22-yard line. There is a flag down. It might have been a push in the back. We'll check it and see what it is. It should be against Cooper. And I believe it was, let's see, the flag was thrown at the 26-yard line, about 2 yards shy of the first down. We'll check and see, as I believe Jones got enough for the first down, but we'll see. There's 7:01 on the third quarter clock. Howe leading 27-14. The officials are still talking about it. Personal foul against Howe. And a personal foul against Cooper. So we'll replay the down. We'll see where they spot the football. Coach Zach Hudson talking to the official over there. Not real happy, obviously, about it, but they're going to move the ball back to the...
backed it up, and they're going to move it back because they had it.
Well, they're going to spot it. Yeah, it'll be a first down at the 22-yard line. So first and 10 for Cooper. Now knocking on the door. McGraw on a busted play is hit. Stump Matthews just absolutely destroyed Jones. The ball was tossed to the right side. Howe says they have the football. No indication yet. And I believe it was Cooper has it at the 24. It was a busted play.
Tristan Matthews made the stop.
They'll actually spot it at the 25, so a loss of three on the plays. Stump was right there, just actually busted Jones in the backfield. It'll be second down and 13. Dalton Felder will move over as linebacker on this near side, trying to stop that toss sweep. Here comes the toss sweep to the right side. And this is going to be Jones who breaks out to the 20 and gains about 5 yards. But that'll still be shy of the first down by about eight after the loss a moment ago. It'll be third and about eight for Cooper. 6:01 on the third quarter clock. Howe had a chance to really blow the doors open a moment ago, but Hawthorne fumbled in the end zone as he was going towards that end zone. Would have been down at the five, but that gave Cooper the ball back. And here they are driving at the 20-yard line. Toss, left side. Ira Franklin trying to find the edge, and he's brought down on a great play right at the line of scrimmage. Actually, maybe a loss of a yard.
Dalton Felder run him down.
It'll be fourth down and nine for the Cooper Bulldogs. Is just an absolutely great defensive play by Dalton Felder right there. Howe leads 27-14. We are in the third quarter. As I'll update that, because I believe it still says half on the screen. So here we go, Cooper under center on fourth and nine. This will be McGraw wanting to throw, coming near side, down the field, and it is incomplete. A flag is thrown as Marzinski hit the receiver just a little bit early. It was it was intended for Hadley Warden, but Marzinski hit him just a little bit early. I believe it was Gibson who the intended receiver was, and that'll be a penalty against Howe. And that will give Cooper a first down. A very, very costly penalty. I'm not sure the catch would have been made. It was on the money, and Gibson might have made the catch. So it may be off or not anyway. But here's McGraw with a new set of downs for Cooper. Toss left side. And right up the middle goes a new running back into the game, and that's Colby Early. And some pushing and shoving going on as Cooper and Howe are really getting into some arguments. I believe that's Tyler Grisham and Tristan Jones get into it at about the 15-yard line. Flags fly everywhere, and these are going to be penalties, probably offsetting, but we'll check and see as a little extracurricular activity going down on the field.
You know, and that both those boys are pretty big. I don't know if I've been one guy in between them.
Boy, Howe is really upset. The coaching staff extremely, extremely upset as they call offsetting penalties, personal fouls on each team. And the Bulldogs coaching staff is extremely upset. Coach Hudson halfway out on the field talking to the official. And apparently Howe saw that that should have been on Cooper and not on Howe, but it is offsetting penalty. There has been no ejections in the game. Everyone's still on the field. Tristan Jones still in the game for Cooper. Tyler Grisham still in the now Jones will actually check out. He's not tossed from the game, but he did just check out of the game. He'll be replaced by Colton Strode. And now Ira Franklin comes in to replace Strode. Strode was discouraged. He was going to get to come in for a moment. You could see the breath just kind of come out of him when Franklin came into the game. And now you hear the crowd coming to their feet on the Cooper side because Hadley Warden raises his arms to get the crowd going. And you can hear him. And you can see across the way the Howe crowd cheering as well. Ball resting at the 8-yard line. Howe had a chance a moment ago to really blow the doors open in this football game, but Hawthorne fumbled in the end zone to give Cooper the ball. Here they are knocking on Howe's door. McGraw is going to toss left side. Franklin, lots of room. He's got the 10. He's got the 5. And he's hit right there at the 4-yard line. A nice hit. And I believe that's going to be Felder, I believe, on that far side.
Our spotter marking it as Tyler Grisham.
Well, Grisham playing a whale of a game tonight. 4:26 left to go in the third quarter. Howe on top, 27-14, but Cooper really pushing for it right here. It's going to be third and goal from the 5. And I would imagine this is 4-down territory. So you got 2 shots at least from Cooper coming right at you. Jones is back into the game, and he will be the fullback. He's got 2 touchdowns tonight. He gets the toss here, right side. He's met, dives forward for a couple of yards, and it'll be 4th down and goal from about the 2.5.
Tanner Hartsfield, Mike Heppenstall, and Tristan Matthews was the group that stopped him.
This is a ginormous play.
Yes, it is.
4:02 and rolling in the third. Howe on top, 27-14. Cooper trying to score on 4th and goal from the 2. Looks like Cooper's going to call a timeout. And we will take 1-2. We'll be back in just a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Restaurant is family owned and run. They have the cure for all your home cooking cravings. Chicken fried steak, loaded baked potato, bacon patty melt, grilled chicken salad, cheese fries, jalapeno stuffed peppers, and more. Don't forget to save room for that cheesecake and cobbler with ice cream. We know you're going to love the food and the service. Abby's Restaurant in downtown Howe. They're open from 11 to 8, Monday through Saturday. Give them a call, 903-487-8860. Abby's Restaurant. The Bulldog.
Welcome back.
Okay, while we've got a timeout, we're going to talk about this. You brought up Roy City. You have brought up Lone Oak.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm going to tell you that S&S is on top of Lone Oak.
No way.
26-14.
No possible way. They've probably got the score reversed like I had ours reversed for about a few minutes, about a quarter.
You know, you brought it up.
That can't happen. It's not going to happen. S&S is not going to beat Lone Oak.
Well, they got them on top right now.
Can't happen. see. Right now, Cooper trying to punch it in here. Huge play. Fourth and goal from the two. Early in the backfield along with Jones. Toss right side Jones. He's met at the line of scrimmage and breaks free. Dives over. Dives in the end zone and is in. Touchdown, Cooper. As Jones was stopped at the one and then just dove to the right side, right at the hash, and scored. That's a huge touchdown for Cooper and a huge swing as the fumble by Hawthorne in the end zone comes back to haunt the Howe Bulldogs. It actually turns out to be a 14-point swing.
Yeah, it did.
Incredible. Incredible. So the PAT will be a 2-point conversion as Franklin into the game, and he gets the toss, and he fumbles the football. It's on the ground, and Overby recovers. So no 2-point conversion, and we have a 7-point game here, 27-20, with Howe in the lead with 3:43 left to go in this third quarter. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HoweEnterprise.com.
Bulldogs make the playoffs and you get the payoff. Hi, this is Chris with Cavender Home Theater. Through November, we're going to give you a $100 Visa gift card just for signing up for Dish with Cavender Home Theater. That's on top of $400 in discounts and free installation. So get the hopper with the best DVR, more HD channels, commercial skip on recorded primetime shows, and lots of apps like Sports Finder and TV Anywhere. Upgrade your home and save money. Visit us at CavenderTV.com or call us at 903-892-3499. Local service is always better. Go Bulldogs!
For my family, life is a series of celebrations. From my newest born cousin to my grandmother. We all partake in births, weddings, and funerals. Wherever we celebrate, we need to feel welcome. That's why we choose Scoggins Funeral Home and Howe. Scoggins Funeral Home understands our needs. Talk to the caring staff at Scoggins Funeral Home. Call 903-532-5577 or visit ScogginsFuneralHome.com.
Welcome back to Princeton's Jackie Hendricks Stadium. 3:43, and this is going to be a terrible kick.
Not real sure what happened there.
I believe it was supposed to be an onside kick. And I've never seen a ball go backwards before.
I haven't either.
Now, I've seen that by one of my fourth grade kickers when we tried to kick it onside. And but it went backwards. This ball went backwards.
It didn't just go way backwards. It went way backwards.
How does a statistician take a kickoff backwards?
I don't know.
So Howe takes over now at the Cooper 32-yard line. Just see, they kicked it from the 40. The ball's at the 32.
Yeah. I'm not real sure what happened.
I've never seen anything like this. Stuff like that usually happens in Wichita Falls at the Voodoo Palace. First and 10, Howe. And this is going to be a handoff to Grisham, right side. And he barrels his way through for about 5 or 6 yards inside the 30 to the 28. So it looks like
Justin Gibson made the stop.
We have an injured player, a Cooper Bulldog, down at the 29-yard line. And it looks like it's going to be Early, Colby Early, that's down on the field. Or maybe it's Gibson. It is actually Early. Colby Early is down. And right now, it looks like this might be an extended delay as Howe is leaving the field at the moment. They may just be going over there to discuss some things with Zach Hudson and head coach or offensive coordinator Dale West. But right now, the Cooper Bulldog, Colby Early, is down at the 28-yard line. We're going to take a quick timeout because every time we do, the young man will get up. So hopefully that will happen. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HoweEnterprise.com.
GCEC Wireless, located in Van Alstine off of Exit 51, can help you with all your Verizon wireless needs. They have a wide range of products and services, including smartphones, wireless home and mobile internet, wireless home phone service, and accessories. They're also your local DirecTV dealer. So come on by or call them at 903-712-2355. That's GCEC Wireless. And go Bulldogs!
Think back to the best fried pie you've ever had. It won't compare to Sweetie Pies in Van Alstine. They have handmade apricot, apple, peach, buttermilk, chocolate, coconut, and lemon fried pies that melt in your mouth. Located at 120 South Main Street in Van Alstine on the east side of downtown. Give them a call at 903-71. Think back to the best fried pie.
Welcome back as Colby Early gets up and he's going to tug at his right knee a little bit. And looks like he was going to walk off the field, and now he kind of stops for a moment, and now will slowly, very slowly, make his way off the field. And it's something to do with his right leg, right knee, but he is really walking slowly.
Yeah, he is. And
so, you know, Early is the young man who kicked it a moment ago. He's their kicker. And he's the young man who kicked it backwards 8 yards. And here is Howe coming back on the field as Blevins will bring the play in. And it'll be second down and 7 for Howe, moving right to left. This will be a handoff to Hawthorne up the middle. He'll gain 2 to the 26. And we're under 3 minutes in the third quarter. Howe leading by a touchdown, 27 to 20.
Walker Ritchie made the stop for the Bulldogs.
Walker. All right.
Walker Ritchie.
That's a cool guy.
It is, isn't it? You know, I'm not real sure what's going on in S&S, but Roy City, but S&S lost. That was 26 points.
I knew something 14. Was wrong. Here's a handoff. Hawthorne, big hole up the middle. He's got the 20 inside the 20 to the 19 and a first down.
Yeah, it's 19-14 again, so I'm not sure what's going on.
I knew something was wrong there, but S&S still leading 19-14, huh?
Yeah, still on top.
That's nuts. Nuts.
Oh.
Hawthorne a little bit gimpy on that last play. And he's still in the game, but he is not at 100% right here. Lopez hands off to Grisham on the right side, and he will move forward to almost the 15. They'll say he stopped just shy. And now Hawthorne will check out. And coming into the football game will be Brent Masters.
Justin Gibson made the stop for the Bulldogs.
Now Masters comes into the game, and I believe this is his first varsity action. And he'll face a 2nd-and-7 situation with 1:25 left to go in the third. This will be a handoff, Grisham. Left side, bowls over one defender and carries about 3 Cooper Bulldogs to the 11-yard line as Grisham just plowed over a couple of defenders.
Yeah, Tanner Pfeiffer and Tristan Jones on the bottom of that pile.
Third. Well, there's a defensive penalty. We'll see what this is going to be. And we're hearing from our fellow broadcasters as defensive offsides, and that's what the official says. So this will spot the ball inside the 11-yard line, about where Grisham went down. So instead of being third, it'll be 2nd down and 2. 1:15 on the third quarter clock. Masters comes back into the game as Hawthorne still not ready to come in yet. Colby Yank brings the play in. Lopez will go under center. And this will be a handoff on the reverse to Brandon Wall. Coming near side, he's got the five and tripped up from behind. Has enough for the first down, but he just didn't have that burst. And you think, you know, you hate to compare kids, but when Carroll runs that reverse, he has that burst of speed to clear on out, and he would have scored.
Yep.
There is no doubt. But Wall, a sophomore, just didn't have that burst on that particular play. 39 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Howe up 27-20. Looking for more right here at the 6-yard line. First and goal. Lopez, handoff. Tyler Grisham trying to find his way with his left hand on the back of one of his blockers and the right hand covering the ball, and he will make his way inside the 5 to the 4-yard line. It'll be second and goal from the 4.
Colby Early back in the game for the Bulldogs. He's the one that made the stop.
I doubt we'll have another play here in the third quarter as we're at the 5-second mark, and that will be the end of the third quarter. We will take a quick timeout. When we come back, it'll be fourth quarter time in Texas in the playoffs. We'll be back with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
You've ever had. It won't compare.
It's way too hot for your vehicle's AC to go out. Head over to 4A Automotive and Howe for their special air conditioning service checkup for just $39.95. For over 10 years, they've provided the most reliable and dependable service and repairs in the area. 4A Automotive is a bumper-to-bumper service shop. They do it all, from autos to diesels, and they're front-end specialists, too. So call 4A Automotive today at 903-546-0024. They're located 4 miles east of Howe at the corner of FM 902 and Luella Road.
Welcome back to Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Monty Walker along with Michael Mosier and the rest of the gang. When we, when the Bulldogs come back out on the field, they're going to face a second down and 4 situation as we enter the fourth quarter. Howe leading 27-20. This could have been a really different game had Hawthorne not fumbled in the third quarter. It was turned out to be a 14-point swing as Cooper got the ball at their own 20 and drove the length of the field and ended up scoring on another Jones touchdown. So instead of 7 points for Howe, it turned out to be 7 points for Cooper. And if this game ends up being tied or you're just going to look back at that moment and say, what if?
Yeah.
And I hope that doesn't happen to the Howe Bulldogs.
Yeah, I don't either. I hope it goes our way. You know, I hope we don't have to look back at that moment.
I think if you're in a situation here, if you face a fourth down and you're inside the 5 like this, don't you have to kick it here?
I would think so.
With a 7-point lead, hopefully we won't have to see that because it's only second down. Lopez, actually Brandon Wall, goes under center, and he will hand off to Grisham left side, who gains maybe 1, maybe back to the line of scrimmage at the 4-yard line. So third down.
Tanner.
Hawthorne now is into the game.
Tanner Pfeiffer in on the stop for the Bulldogs.
Good news for Bulldog fans as Anthony Hawthorne is back into the football game. It's third down and goal from the 4. Hartsfield breaks the huddle, comes to the line of scrimmage. Here comes everybody else. Lopez under center. Hawthorne all alone in the backfield. Man in motion is Brandon Wall. Hand off Hawthorne left side. Met at the line of scrimmage. Fourth down. But we're going to find out whether he sends Bryce Honaker out there to try to extend this lead. But as of right now, it's fourth and goal from the 5. And here comes Bryce Honaker. It should be a 21-yard field goal. We'll see where they spot the tee, and that's exactly where it is. A 21-yard field goal attempt by the freshman Bryce Honaker. He has been near perfect all year, and this is well within his range. Off from the left hash, high snap brought down by Ross. It's a low kick, and it just sneaks through.
Boy, just
barely sneaks through. And Howe extends their lead 30-20 with 10:40 left to go in this football game. Back in a moment with more Howe Bulldog football on HowEnterprise.com.
Calling all Bulldog fans. fans to come down to the Sonic and Howe for half-price shakes after 8 and open until midnight, home games only, where you get great food and big smiles. And a little message for all our Howe football players, go Bulldogs fight, Bulldogs win, win, win. Because it's not just good, it's Sonic good.
You're invited to the one and only Buck's North Barbecue in downtown Van Alstine, Texas. Your friends and neighbors say it's the best barbecue in North Texas. Now it's your turn to decide. Come taste the difference at Buck's North Barbecue. For complete store information, including menu, location, and hours, click on BucksNortBarbecue.com. That's BucksNortBBQ.com. Buck's North Barbecue in downtown Van Alstine is a proud supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
Here we are in Princeton, and Howe with a 10-point lead with 10:40 left to go. And with those points, here's the high pooch kick going to be taken at the 22-yard line. And right up the middle of the field goes Cooper, but the ball is placed on the turf by the young man, but covered up by Cooper again. So that was Colton Strode who actually returned it to the 46-yard line. The ball hit the turf, but Cooper recovered. Now, we do have a new school record as Howe now with 30 points is the most points that Howe's ever scored in the playoffs. The previous high was 28. And that was done twice against Pilot Point in 1998. First and 10, Cooper. He's gonna fake a couple of reverses and a great block. And McGraw will gain about 8 to 9 yards on the first down play as Dalton Felder was just lit up on the edge. And McGraw rode that block to the far side and makes his way to the 45 inside Howe territory.
J.P. Queen in on the stop for the Bulldogs.
Here comes McGraw on second and short. Toss right side, and that's Franklin who's met in the backfield. Tyler Grisham along with, I believe that's Helpinstell, and that'll be a loss for one of the very few times tonight for Franklin. A loss of about 2 to bring up 3rd and 4 for Cooper with 9:37 on the clock. Howe leading by 10, 30-20. Desperately trying to hang on here in Princeton tonight and advance and win in the playoffs for the first time since 2003. 3rd and 4. Wing set for Cooper. Toss right side. Franklin initially goes up the middle and then turns out left side. He's going to have a first down to the 43-yard line. Got just a yard more than what he needed for the first. Dalton, that'll move the sticks.
Dalton Felder made the stop.
So ball rests at the 43. What Howe needs is to get the football and just eliminate the clock here. Austin Bearden checks into the football game. And this will be, whistles are blown before this one can get underway. It's going to be against Cooper, a false start. And it looked like that's probably a good thing that happened because Jones had clear room to run on the left side.
Yeah, I think if that whistle hadn't have blown, he would have scored a touchdown.
That very well could have happened. At least initially the look on that play looked very, very dangerous to Howe as that'll push the ball back to the 48 just shy of midfield in Howe territory. So it'll be first down and 15 now for Cooper. Under center goes McCroy. No shotgun formations for either team tonight. It'll be a toss. Left side, Jones slips him initially, but then breaks out of a tackle and runs right over. I believe that's Mrzynski. He just plowed and trucked Mrzynski, but Mrzynski will get credit for the tackle.
Yeah, he was.
And that'll push the ball up to the 45. A gain of about 3 as we set second down and 12 with 8:22 as Jones got out of bounds to stop the clock. Checking in, bringing in the play for Cooper will be Hadley Warden. And he'll split out up the top, wide right. Two men in the backfield. Wing formation, toss. And Franklin initially goes left and cuts it back right. It's brought down after maybe a two-yard gain. And now Cooper faces third and 10. And I'm telling you what, if I'm Cooper, I'm running a toss to the right side because Franklin has yet to be stopped on that particular play.
Right. Yeah, every time they go right, he goes right. He's hard to bring down.
He's got room to run when they run that toss sweep to the right side. But luckily for the Howe Bulldogs and their fans, they haven't run that play in quite some time. And here's a crucial third and 10 situation. Cooper, toss right side. And that'll be Franklin again, and he's bottled up at about the 40 after a gain of about 3. That's one of those where he just tosses out to the right side, and Franklin cuts it up toward the middle almost every time. It was good early on in the game, but that play hasn't worked probably since the first quarter. It'll be fourth and 7, and we'll see what Cooper elects to do here, as I don't see any indication of a punt. This is gut check time for Cooper and the Howe Bulldogs. Fourth and 6 with 7 minutes to go. McGraw under center from the 40. Rolls out right side. Looking to throw. A man in his face throws it down the field. And it is intercepted by Hawthorne at the 15-yard line. That probably would have been better suited for Howe to just drop the football. That might have been Griffin, actually, on the interception.
Actually, I think it was Marinsky.
Was it Marzinski?
Yep.
Yeah, it might have been. I guess it was Marzinski. My apologies. 6:48 left to go in the game, and now Howe takes over. And like I said, if he would have just knocked the ball down, Howe would have had it, you know, well close to midfield. But right now, the ball will rest at the 16-yard line. So Howe will have it at their own 16. Need to kill about 4 minutes off this clock, at least, is what Howe wants to do. 6:48 on the clock. Howe leading by 10 with the ball. Hand off to Grisham. To the left side, he breaks free for a moment and slung down at the 27-yard line. Enough for a first down. An 11-yard run by Tyler Grisham, and he's having a game of his life.
Yes, he is. Dally Warner made the stop for Cooper.
They'll spot the ball at the 26-yard line. As Howe will now take their time. 6:29 and rolling.
You know, there's quite a few people on that Howe side. It's great to see. With this cool weather we got,
Here's Grisham again with the carry. Bottled up a little bit this time. And the whistles finally blow. But Grisham kept moving the pile and gained 3 yards, maybe even 4. Whereas he was met initially after a 1 yard gain, but Grisham never quit fighting, and they'll spot the ball at the 30.
Yeah, I think the officials were waiting on Jack Kane to get in there. Everybody else was in there. I think they were just waiting on him to get there.
A little worried. Once, you know, that's how injuries happen in those kinds of plays. It worked out in Howe's favor that time as Grisham got another couple of yards. And it'll be second down and 7. Here's a handoff to Grisham again, left side. This time not much doing. He's down at about the 30.
It looks
like a fumble has happened. And Cooper has it. Cooper has recovered a fumble at the Howe 30-yard line. Grisham put it on the turf. And with 5:23, don't go anywhere yet.
Colby Early come up with a fumble for the Cooper Bulldogs.
So costly fumbles. As Howe really, if Howe doesn't fumble in this football game, it's not even really much of a contest. But turnovers are becoming very costly. As here's McCraw as he trips as he was trying to sprint out, and it looked like he was wanting to throw on the rollout to the near side, but he simply tripped over his feet, fell down, loss of about five, and that'll move the ball back to the 34. Three backs in the backfield, T formation, split out wide right, and this will be a handoff to the left side and bottled up and caught in the backfield.
Austin Bearden and Dalton Felder in on the stop.
Franklin had nowhere to go as he was brought down. They'll give him forward progress to the line of scrimmage, but he had absolutely nowhere to go, and it's third down and 15 for Cooper.
You know, Cooper they don't capitalize, and you know, that's, I think Howe takes the ball over, and we run the clock out, and we play again next week.
Third and 13. Under center goes McCraw. Rolling out to the near side, wanting to throw the football. Pressure in his face. Nearly sacked, and now sacked in the backfield. Queen gets him at the 48, a huge loss. And now a late flag comes in right at the pile. It looks like Howe maybe it will be against Howe. It will be excessive celebration.
That is a huge penalty.
That is unbelievable. As Howe had Cooper trapped at the 48, and now that'll spot the ball all the way back up and give Cooper life again at the 33-yard line. So Howe had McCraw sacked at the 48, and then the personal foul gives him a first down.
Yep.
Oh, you can't just make this stuff up.
No.
First and 10, Cooper moving right to left. McCraw under center, toss right side. Jones, he's being chased down by Overby, and he will gain 1 yard. Overby ran lateral right down the line and actually dove and grabbed his feet, and it gave him time for some others to get there, including Stump Matthews. And it'll be no gain, actually, on the play. And it'll bring up second down and 10 from the 33.
Okay, remember, you said you can't make this stuff up. It's 33-21 SNS.
You're kidding me. You are kidding me. Second and 10, toss, right side, halfback pass, throwing back to McCraw on the backside, and Howe sniffs it out pretty good as Griffin, the freshman, was there. And also, I believe Tanner Hartsfield and J.P. Queen were also there. It will be a gain of about five or six inside the 30 to the 28-yard line, but brings up a third and four situation. Cooper trying to take advantage of a very costly fumble and a very costly penalty by Howe. Third and four. Cooper trailing by 10. McCraw wants to throw down the field, looking for the end zone, and it is incomplete. Brzezinski was in coverage along with Easton Ross, trying to hit his wide out, the receiver Jack Kane, but it fell incomplete. Kane, 6'2", 170, tall, slender receiver, but he was just overthrown by a step or two by McCraw.
Marinsky just threw his hands up in the air going, I didn't touch him.
So now it comes down to this. It's fourth and four. And Howe, if they can hold, will have 2 minutes and 24 delicious seconds left in this football game. Leading by 10, 30 to 20. Fourth and four. Here we go. McCraw. He's going to fake the hand, fake the reverse. He's going to roll out to the right side. And he is brought down at the 30-yard line. Howe will take over on downs. No flags. Now the officials are talking about something. But Howe is celebrating. And it will be Howe ball at the 31-yard line.
Yeah, there was a flag, but I think it was against
Cooper. It was against Cooper. It will be declined. And Howe will have the football with 2:09 left to go in this game. Ball at their own 31-yard line. And that 4th and 4 was humongous.
Yes, it was.
30-20, Howe in the lead with 2:09 left to go in the game. All Howe has to do is kill the clock.
They kill the clock, and that's
what Howe does best.
That's right.
They chew up the clock, and that's what they have to do here. And Howe, well, now whistles blow before this one can get underway. The officials want to talk. Looks like they're bringing in a new football. They're bringing in a new football. So now the officials are talking to Howe. The Coach Hudson went out there to talk to him. And now Howe with 2:09 just needs to chew this clock, get a first down, handoff. Right side by Grisham, and that shows a lot of faith in Tyler Grisham, as the last time he touched the ball, he put it on the turf, but he keeps it there and runs it on the first play, and it will be 2nd down and 9. Now, a timeout's been taken by Cooper. 5 seconds ran off the clock on that play, so 2:04 left to go in the game.
Yeah, I guess that takes them down to 1 timeout left.
We still have a 33-21 lead by S&S over Lone Oak, and I still can't wrap my head around that one. That's just unbelievable. Unbelievable. And you know what? I'm not sure they don't have that score reversed, because no one can see S&S's numbers. You know, their numbers are so hard to read.
Right.
they may just not know. They're just making up a score.
There you go.
The coaching staff is packing up their film equipment. They're ready to get out of here. There's 2:04 left on the clock, though. Howe in the lead, 30-20. Already a school record, 30 points, the most points Howe's ever scored in a playoff game. The old record was 28.
Lopez under center.
And here comes Lopez. He sends a man in motion. Hand off Hawthorne. Right side, big hole. And he bangs his way to the 40-yard line. A yard shy of the first down. And Hawthorne slow to get up again, as he will now be helped. And another timeout's been called. We'll keep it right here. 1:59 left to go in this game. If Howe picks up this first down, it's over.
That's right.
There's 2 yards left in between Howe and this playoff win. 2 yards separates 11 years of playoff drought in the win column. 2003 was the last time Howe won a playoff game. It was against Grand Saline. It was 21-14. And these Howe Bulldogs are about to eliminate 11 years of heartache. And I tell you what, there's a victory light in Howe.
Yes, there is.
It's not where you think it is. But that victory light that came off the old press box, if Howe can wrap this one up, I have a feeling you'll see it in downtown Howe sometime tomorrow, hopefully. Here is a handoff to Hawthorne, and he's met at the line of scrimmage. He got one. I don't think he got enough for the first, as now there's 1:45 on the clock. And I think Howe's, I mean, you might as well go for it here. At their own 40, it's 4th and 1. You snap the ball at about a minute. If you don't get it, Cooper's still down by 10. They have to score twice regardless. So going for it right here is not that risky. Not as risky. Obviously, if you were only leading by seven, you don't even think about it. You just punt the ball away. But up by two scores, I think you've got a chance to go ahead and plow forward. I think they're going to – they might just
– And Howe called timeout.
Yeah, I believe they're going to go for it here. There's 1:14 on the clock. Howe leading 30-20. This is, you know, this is pretty – this is why those coaches get paid big bucks.
That's right.
Yeah, this is an interesting decision here. You're up by 10. 1:14 left. If you make the first down, if you get 1 yard, the ball game's over. There's no question about it. If you don't, you give Cooper the ball. They don't have any timeouts. They can't stop the clock, and they're down by two scores. So, to me, you just go for it and try to get that 1 yard and put the nail in the coffin. But we'll see what Howe does here. I just don't think you'd see a punt in this situation. Cooper sends their punt return team out as if Howe will punt, as McGraw will go back deep along with Colton Strode. And now they kind of come forward a little bit, as I believe the coaching staff told them, hey, I'm not sure they're going to punt. And they're not. Howe comes on the field. Hawthorne in the backfield, along with Tyler Grisham. Lopez goes under center. 4th and 1. Here we go, trying to close out this football game. Handoff. First down. First down for the Bulldogs on Hawthorne's handoff to the right side. And Howe has 1:10 delicious seconds left to go in this football game.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, it kind of just shuts them out right there. That, Howe runs the time off the clock, and we get on the bus, load up, and we play again next Friday.
I tell you what, this is one of those football games where you just say thank you, because there were costly penalties and turnovers, especially turnovers in this game. 14-point swing. Howe now in the victory formation. Joaquin Lopez takes a knee with 43 seconds on the clock, and one more play should do it. I think they'll have to run one more.
Yeah, there'll be about 4 seconds left.
I think that's right. Yep, there'll be about 4 seconds left on the clock. Victory formation again for Howe. Lopez under center, takes a knee. Howe, your Bulldogs have won a playoff game for the first time in 11 years. Coach Zach Hudson, in his second year in Howe, has made the playoffs and turned this program completely around. He ties Arthur Boyle on the all-time win list with his 9th win. Tip your hats to the Howe Bulldogs. They are bi-district champions. We'll be back in just a moment with more Howe Bulldog football and wrap this one up here at Jackie Hendricks Stadium in just a moment on HowEnterprise.com.
The Howe Athletic Booster Club invites you to become a supporter of the Howe Bulldogs.
The type of kids we have, they're just hard workers and do anything you ask.
Memberships are $25 and will be available at all home games. All proceeds benefit high school and middle school athletic programs. Please join the Howe Athletic Booster Club in our efforts to support our hometown kids.
When people come here, you know, it's something they can be proud of.
The Howe Enterprise has served Howe as the hometown news since 1963. Since then, the Bulldogs have won 8 district, 7 bi-district, 3 area championships, and 1 regional title. We've seen 14 different head coaches during that time. The Howe Enterprise has been with the Bulldogs for 51 years. We were there when the pride of Howe won 3 band state championships. HoweEnterprise.com publishes weekly on Mondays.
Welcome back to a very, very happy Jackie Hendricks Stadium here in Princeton, as Howe will group on that far north side to play their school song and the fight song here in just a moment. Very happy Howe Bulldogs on the field. Just an exciting night overall. for the Howe Bulldogs football program. Everything has changed in 2 years. And bringing in offensive coordinator Dale West to bring in the slot T just transformed this program. Not only the attitude by Zach Hudson a year ago and the defense that he's been able to bring in for this program, but Dale West, you got to give him a lot of credit too, bringing that slot T. It's his first year to ever coach the slot T alone without his mentor. But look at the Howe Bulldogs down on the field.
Right.
They are just going crazy.
And I don't know if you noticed, but Coach West, they handed him the trophy, and he was down there polishing it, making it look good.
Coach Hudson was walking towards the 8-yard line, finally finished there, but all the players were just following Coach Hudson like little puppy dogs. Wherever he walked, they just followed him. And they're all having a talk down there right now, and Anthony Hawthorne just kind of walking around behind, and I'm not sure he's leaving his football game completely healthy. He gets a slap on the behind from Joaquin Lopez, and Coach Hudson with an extremely, extremely emotional talk, I can only imagine down there on the field. Let's go over some final stats for you here from Jackie Hendricks Stadium. Hawthorne finished with 26 carries, 129 yards, and 2 touchdowns. His longest run of the night was 38, which he scored upon. Brandon Wall had 4 carries for 17 yards. Joaquin Lopez, 3 carries for 9 yards. And Tyler Grisham carried 19 times for 94 yards. It's the first time Howe has won a football game where two rushers didn't go over 100 yards. But Tyler Grisham came really close with 94. As a team, well, I actually don't have the receiving part. Tyler Grisham made the only reception tonight, and it didn't gain anything on that, but it was the one reception of the night. For the Cooper Bulldogs, they end their season with a 7-4 record in the bi-district final. It was Jaden McCraw who was 1 out of 5. He completed that one pass for 11 yards. Jaden McCraw ran 3 times for 2 yards. Ira Franklin was all over the place, 21 carries, 153 yards. His longest was 27. Colby Early had a carry for 3 yards, and Tristan Jones, 14 carries for 70 yards and 3 touchdowns. So both teams played very competitive. It came down to turnovers, which it always does in big football games, and Howe lost a couple of them, and Tyler Grisham picked off one, and just had the, you know, if you have to pick a player of the game, it's pretty obvious tonight that Tyler Grisham, and then, well, there's a moment, Stratton Carroll makes his way on the field with his crutches and all, and the team just, they just go crazy and run to him. And what a moment that has to be right there for Stratton Carroll, as they just all swarm around him, and you could hear him yell. And now the team will take a knee around Carroll, and it looks like they're all going to say a word of prayer. What a great moment. Absolutely fantastic moment here at Jackie Hendricks Stadium for this Howe Bulldog football program.
Yeah, it is. And that's well-deserved. Well-deserved. Coach Hudson is a absolutely fantastic gentleman. I thank a lot of Coach Hudson, thank a lot of Coach West, and the entire coaching staff. And those kids and those coaches have done a great job.
You know, I talked to Coach West before the game, and was trying to get some insight on what might happen tonight. And we talked for a little bit, and he turned back. As I was walking away, he just said, "Hey, I hope you say it's touchdown time in Texas a lot tonight."
Yeah, about 2 weeks ago, I saw him, and he told me we were going to say that a lot. And, we said it quite a few times that night.
It looks like S&S is still leading Lone Oak 33-21.
I don't know. That blows my mind.
It does mine as well. But we'll see.
You know, there's another fantastic gentleman that was at one time in Howe. And, you know, I know we're bitter enemies, but Garrett Patterson is he's a great guy.
You know, I have to mention that when we went to S&S, they were complete class over there. It was a wonderful experience. And what a great group of people over there in S&S. So tonight, the final from Princeton, 30-20. Howe wins a playoff game for the first time in 11 years, back since 2003 when they defeated Grand Saline 21-14. Howe sets a playoff record tonight with 30 points. The most points Howe had ever had in a playoff game prior to tonight was 28 when they accomplished that twice, once against Roy City in 1989, and, of course, that classic in Denton against Pilot Point in 1998. For everyone who's been a part of this one, including Michael Mosier and Stephen Braswell, we appreciate everything they do every week. We will see you next week as the Howe Bulldogs advance. For everyone who's been a part of this one, I'm Monty Walker. So long, everybody.
You've been listening to Howe Bulldogs Football. Howe Bulldogs Football has been brought to you by
Abby's Restaurant, GCEC Wireless, Scoggins Funeral Home, Bucksnort Barbecue, Cavender Home Theater, SAP Consulting, Sweetie Pies,
Fast Signs, Curie's Coffee Company,
4A Automotive, and Sonic.
He pushes his way in. It is touchdown time in Texas for the first time in the 2014 season. Take me.